bulls, broad stripes, and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Patrick Blackwell with our national anthem. The Cubs will try to keep the power bats working. 7 home runs the last 2 games, both wins. Lineups in the first. Baseball on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you in part by Chevy. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealer today. Walgreens, the pharmacy of the Chicago Cubs. Your local area Lexus dealer who invites you to test drive a Lexus today. Aflac, ask about it at work. Toyota, choose any direction as long as it's moving forward. Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Visit us at geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, shining through. Your local Lincoln Mercury dealers. Check out our new models at lincolnmercury.com. Midas, trust the Midas touch. Corona, miles away from the ordinary. And by Southwest Airlines, nonstop service to over 59 destinations all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom.
Chevy Malibu LT versus Toyota Camry XLE V6. Malibu offers a better value for the money than Camry. Malibu has a flat fold front passenger seat, not Camry. Malibu even has better fuel economy. Proof once again that all cars are not created equal. Now use Hot Button Bonus to lease a 2005 Chevy Malibu with these attractive lease offers. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealer today.
Calling the Mach 5. Come in, Speed. Trixie, calling the Mach 5.
I'm in the middle of a race, Trixie. Don't talk to me now.
Speed, listen to me. The bridge is out ahead. You're in extreme danger.
The bridge is out?
Don't worry, Speed. I have good news.
Tell me, Trixie.
I just saved a bunch of money on my car insurance by switching to Geico.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Can I clear these for you? Okay, let me just... I'll just take these out of your way, okay? Done? What about these? Are you guys done? Yeah, there we go.
Wow, you know what? That new busboy you hired? He's really working his butt off.
Yeah. I didn't hire a busboy.
This summer, grab some Coors or Coors Light. Look for specially marked packages for your chance to win never-released-before music downloads powered by Sony from Kinect.com. Taste the cold. Get the music.
Welcome back to Wrigley Field. 60 degrees, humidity at 58%. The wind's out of the southwest today at 10, and some lucky fans getting some autographs today on the field as the Cubs have just taken the field behind right-hander Sergio Mitre. So he gets ready to work, and it'll be his second career appearance against the Colorado Rockies. Let's check out Clint Hurdle's Rockies Southwest starting lineup. Rockies 2-7 on their road trip, hitting 187. Barmas Gonzalez and the struggling Todd Helton 0-11. Believe it or not, in this series. Preston Wilson's had a good series, 5 RBIs and 2 home runs. Brad Hoff is in right. Matt Holliday over in left.
Desi Relaford with his third start at three different positions in this series. And the battery for the Rocks today, Clauser and the lefty, Jeff Francis.
Take a look at our Rico Cubs defense. Du Bois, Patterson, Bernitz once again across the outfield. Ramirez, Perez, happy birthday to Jerry Hairston. Derek Lee at first base. Michael Barrett behind the plate for Sergio Mitre. Mitre coming off a strong outing against the Houston Astros. Seven innings, gave up only five base hits and a couple of runs. Really got into trouble with a leadoff walk that ended up scoring, but really no other damage. You get a look at his numbers on this season.
So it'll be Clint Barmas to lead it off for the Rockies. And the Cubs continuing to make roster moves, especially in the pitching staff. John Lester recalled from AAA Iowa, so he's back again. And that move facilitated by the LaTroy Hawkins trade yesterday to the San Francisco Giants.
That was, you notice, today's transaction. That could be a regular feature the way it's been going around here lately.
The word and the transaction of the day. We are underway. It's a strike on the Rockies rookie shortstop Clint Barmas. Mitre with the 0-1. It's low and outside. Certainly an early rookie of the year candidate in the National League, Clint Barmas. Off to a terrific start. Down the left field line, but foul.
I'm sure, much like every other offensive award that goes to a Colorado Rockies player, I'm sure a lot of people will be biased because he plays half his games at Coors Field. But once again, that's not his fault. That's where he plays. That's where his team plays 81 games a year. I don't fault him for taking advantage of the home field conditions.
Lifted into shallow left center, and it's Du Bois to make the running catch. Four out number one today, and that'll bring up Luis Gonzalez playing second today for Colorado. Again, the Rockies on the road this year, 4-22. They're 2-7 on a road trip that mercifully will end today. They come in hitting 187 on the trip, 123 with runners in scoring position. Averaging under three runs a game and a team ERA of over six on the trip. Kind of says it all. And well, if you don't finish at even 500 at home with that kind of road record, it's going to be a long season. Inside.
You saw the offensive numbers, hitting 317 as a team at home and still unable to get to 500 in their own ballpark.
The 1-1 is upstairs in a fastball. I think the approach right now by Sergio Mitre is, and while he'll definitely try to relax, but I think he understands that nothing is a given right now, even with Mark Pryor on the DL. There's a bouncer in the hole. Perez with the throw to Lee, and two down here in the first inning. Having said all that, I don't think Sergio Mitre necessarily feels comfortable that he's going to continue to pitch in the Cubs rotation, and I guess he'll kind of dictate how much he does pitch in the rotation.
Well, Dusty Baker's pretty much said that. It all depends. You go start to start at this point, and at some point, if he continues to rack up good start after good start, he will earn that vote of confidence and earn a permanent spot in the rotation.
Well, Todd Helton just snapped an 0 for 16, and that is his first hit of the series. He reached on a walk in his first plate appearance on Thursday. This is the second time in a four-game set he's even gotten on base. Pretty amazing.
Well, you'd like to just get him the heck out of town before he figures it out, because you know he's going to figure it out at some point. He's been too good a hitter throughout his career to struggle for very long. And you just hope to keep him quiet today and let him go about his business somewhere else.
Even with a hit, Helton three for his last 43. Preston Wilson's had a solid series, 4 for 9 with a double, two home runs, five RBIs, and he scored three times. Mitre's 1-0, got it past him. Spin move by Wilson.
Very artistic swing and a miss right there by Preston Wilson.
Short lead by Helton. It's bounced foul by Wilson.
Well, so far a good approach by Sergio Mitre on the Rocky center fielder and power hitting cleanup hitter. Got to keep that ball in on his hands with as much movement as possible. A couple of good hard sinkers down and in.
Todd Helton, not much of a threat to run. One stolen base this year. And Michael Barrett with good caught stealing numbers behind the plate. There's a flare over Derek Lee. It'll drop in for Wilson. Helton will stop at third. It is a double for Preston Wilson. Just placed it perfectly. Pulled off the lob wedge and went the other way.
Couple of very funny looking swings in that sequence for Preston Wilson, but it's a good result, at least for him. Breaking ball over the middle of the plate, kind of got fooled, just flicked that ball out there over Derek Lee's head into shallow right field. It didn't even make it to the bullpen mounds down in the corner there. Well, that's going to happen. You have to find a way to pitch around those. Good hitters occasionally are going to get cheap hits, and as a pitcher, you just have to forget about it, go to work on the next guy, although you have to pitch very carefully to Brad Hopp, a left-handed hitter, with the right-hand hitting Matt Holliday on deck.
Too many previous at-bats for the Rockies against Mitre. Hopp is 0 for 3. And Sergio, that pitch is inside on a heater. Of course, it was Hopp who hit the liner off Mark Pryor's elbow 2 days ago. One oh outside corner, according to Andy Fletcher, on balls and strikes today. I was thinking about wearing that very shirt today. Made a late decision to change. Swing and a miss, and it's 1-2.
Good decision. Hate to see two of those in the same ballpark on the same day.
Yep.
I really hate to see one of those in the ballpark.
I don't know if he spilled breakfast on himself or if that's on purpose.
It's ivy growing up from the bottom of the shirt. Yeah.
1-2 pitch. He struck him out. Good fastball at 94. A couple of two out hits for the Rockies, but no runs as they strand a pair in the first.
Some cars are just born to follow, one-dimensional, charisma-free. This car has a different vibe. It takes any road you throw at it and everything you throw in it. Runs fast between lights and long between fill-ups. Give it a destination and go where the vibe takes you. With available cash back and hot button bonus cash, a new vibe starts around 15.7. Non-GM owners and lessees get a new vibe for around 14.7. Hot button bonus cash on all Pontiac models ends May 31st.
It's Erica, the 2005 Loop Rock Girl. I want to say thanks to Chicago for choosing me, and now I have something for you.
It's the Loop's Ultimate Garage Giveaway, a complete garage makeover, including a brand new Chevy Equinox, a stunning Suzuki street bike, a souped-up John Deere riding mower, and more. Listen to 97.9 The Loop and enter your info at WLUP.com today.
Rock Girl not included. Poster for the wall sold separately.
We engineered the 2005 GMC Yukon with the tightest turning radius in its class. We also gave it better city fuel economy than Ford Expedition, available luxury features, and stylish design. So the question isn't how well a Yukon will turn, but where it will turn up. Choose an 05 Yukon with available option package discounts, cash back, and hot button bonus cash for a total value of $5,750. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana GMC dealers.
Every morning on Comcast Sportsnet.
Well, the Cubs will try to finish his homestand at 6-4, and they'll do that with a win today. And now the Cubs starting lineup is written out by Dusty Baker. Jerry Hairston turning 29 today. And he's leading off. Nathy Perez with a six-game hitting streak. Lee Ramirez, Dubois go 3-4-5. Jeremy Brunitz out in right, bat sixth. Corey Patterson in center. He's at a very good homestand. Michael Barrett hot as of late, and Sergio Mitre looks for his first hit this year. And strike one from left-hander Jeff Francis, the consensus minor league player of the year last year. He's a rookie, and he leads the Rockies with four wins. But he's been a heck of a lot better at Coors Field than on the road in his short career. Swatted into center for Jerry Hairston. Good start for the Cubs today. Cubs offense really going the last 2 days, 15 runs.
Yeah, I really believe it all goes back to the meeting that Dusty Baker held with his ball club, encouraging them to try to be more patient. And at least if you are going to swing at the first pitch, make sure it's a ball you want to hit. Cubs up and down the lineup have been much more patient, and when they have attacked early in the count, they've gone after good hitters' pitches.
Now Nathy Perez 2-for-4 with a double yesterday. The Cubs have never faced Jeff Francis. Tall lefty deals, 6'5", 200 pounds, a first-round pick in 2002, born in Vancouver, British Columbia. Seventeenth major league start. He's 7-4 with a 4.99 earned run average. Pop foul back our way, and it's 1-1.
See his numbers on the season. Right-handers hitting much better. Of the five home runs, all have come to right-handed batters this year. Perfect 3-0 at Coors Field this year, 5-0 in his career. That's totally amazing.
1-1 hit in the air to right. Hop coming in now after a brief pause. And one out in the inning, and here comes Derek Lee. Wants two more home runs today. Well, what has he done the last 2 days, you ask? 5-for-6, four home runs, six RBIs, three walks, and five runs. Second time in his career, he's had back-to-back two homer games. He did it as a Marlin back in June of 2002. No Cub has ever had three consecutive multi-homer games. Hairston went back toward first, and the curveball is missed by Lee. So Jared just trying to read the pickoff move of Jeff Francis. He thought he was coming over to first.
And sometimes a base runner will do that intentionally to decoy the pitcher. There's a base running sequence that some teams like to use where you get a one-way lead and then you go on the first move.
Well, he has him picked off, and the tag will be applied by Barmas. That'll go 1-3-6.
Yeah, the theory of that one-way lead and then first move is you get a step bigger than the maximum lead you're comfortable with, and every time the pitcher lifts his foot, you break back to first base. And then you shorten your lead by a couple of steps. The pitcher sees you shortening up your lead, assumes that you can't get a read on his move, and then you break for second on the first move. Sometimes it works. Sometimes you run into an out at second base like Jerry Hairston just did.
It looked like he was running with first movement. Wasn't necessarily looking for a move from Francis. So two outs and a 1-2 count on Lee, and he drills that one on the ground in the left center. He is so locked in.
has to be a moral victory for Jeff Francis to keep him in the ballpark. He's sneaky quick with his fastball, and you talked to Bob Apodaca, the pitching coach, before the game, who compared him very favorably to Tom Glavine, his ability to work the outside corner with his fastball and changeup. And he's got a sneaky pickoff move, as we've already seen.
Yes, we have. Now it's Aramis Ramirez. And a key for Francis, that fastball in the area where Clauser's setting up. Low and outside.
That's a theory that's worked well for Leo Mazzoni and his pitchers down in Atlanta for years. Not really starting with Tom Glavine, but certainly Tom Glavine, a huge proponent of just pounding that outside corner.
And Francis is not overpowering. He'll top out at 90 or 91. You mentioned his numbers at Coors Field. He's 5-0 with a 2.78 ERA and 6 starts at Coors last year and this year. On the road, he's 2-4 with a 6.49. But what's going to give today? Because in the daytime, he has never lost. He's 6-0 with a 2.56 ERA and 9 career daytime starts. But see, the lights are on, so maybe that'll
confuse him out there. Yeah. We get a real overcast day, he might think it's a night game.
Working from the first base side of the rubber, and he'll throw over to Lee. Rather to Helton and Lee back. Derek with 8 stolen bases, leading the Cubs.
And you can overload with all these numbers, day, night, righties, lefties, east of the Mississippi, west of the Mississippi, when the temperature's over 60 or under 60.
Days at end and Y. Lee running, the pitch is high, Clauser's throw gets in the center. So not only is Clauser 0 for 16 now, throwing out base stealers, that's his second error.
Clauser has a strong throwing arm, but at times he'll get out of whack mechanically behind the plate. Start thinking too much about his footwork and doesn't really get his upper body into a good throwing position. Never really quite gets that front shoulder closed, and that causes the throw to sail into center field. Derek Lee advances all the way around to third base.
3-1 on Ramirez. Dubois on deck. The pitch. And hit foul, so 3-2.
When you talk to people close to the Rockies about Jeff Francis, they say that he has a good feel for pitching, which is understandable given the fact he was a physics major at the University of British Columbia. He could probably tell you exactly how many rotations that ball makes on its way to home plate. That's an unfair advantage, a physics major.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Full count on Ramirez, 2 down in the inning. Derek Lee, the runner at third. The payoff pitch is bounded foul. The throwing error by J.D. Clauser, the 40th error by the Rockies this year, most in the National League. Another 3-2 and another foul, so Ramirez getting a good look at the young lefty. So they're last in team ERA, 11th in runs in the National League, and they've committed the most errors. Here comes again, and Ramirez unable to get it down in front of Holiday. Just had too much lift, I guess. So Holiday with a catch, Cubs come up empty, no score.
free to move about the country.
Get an inside perspective of your Chicago Cubs year-round with Vineline, the club's official monthly magazine. Published out of the Cubs' own friendly confines, Vineline delivers expert team analysis, exclusive player features, outstanding photography, and more. Call 1-800-248-9467 to order today and receive a free gift with your subscription. Rates start at just $24.95. Vineline subscriptions are also available at Cubs.com.
This Memorial Day, feel free to drive a new Ford with 0% financing, zero payments all summer long, and zero maintenance for 2 years.
Get the best baseball experience this summer by entering the Crosstown HDTV sweepstakes. It's your chance to win one of three Sony 42-inch HDTV sets during the Crosstown Series June 24th through the 26th. To enter, go to ComcastSportsNet.com, link to Chicago, and fill out your entry, or send in a postcard to the address on the screen. Then watch the Crosstown Series on Comcast Sportsnet to find out if you're a winner. We're giving away three TVs in 3 days, only on Comcast Sportsnet. Nobody does baseball better.
Second inning, Mitre to Matt Holliday, and he pops it foul. Derek Lee is over to watch it drop into the stands. Well, it sure looked like Ramirez was going to be able to knock in Derek Lee, but the liner he hit just kept carrying, and Holliday able to make the catch. Not much wind at all right now. Backhanded by Nafee, and he slipped on the grass. He was just too deep in the hole. And Holliday is aboard with a hit, the third hit for the Rockies here early on.
That tends to happen more often when the infielder plants his heel first rather than the toe of his shoe, and you can see the heel came down, the back cleats came right out from underneath him. And that particular area right there, when the tarp is on the field, sometimes the water runs off, and the area right behind the infield dirt tends to get a little soft just from the water that runs off the tarp over the course of a season.
Relaford with a fly ball to left. And Dubois with a catch. Desi Relaford with the Craig Council type series. He started at second, short, and today at third. The Geico quote from Dusty Baker on not being superstitious, quote, "I'm not a doom and gloom guy, so I really don't believe in jinxes. You go through periods of unfortunate times, but the mark of a man is how you handle it. You can't dwell on the problem. You have to dwell on the solution."
Very well put.
Just move ahead. The Cubs have done that the last 2 days with back-to-back wins.
Can't worry about a bad haircut. You just have to move forward. It's going to grow back.
Might take 4 weeks, but it'll get there eventually. Go on to Clauser, who's a switch hitter, and it's 1-1.
I think Dusty's philosophy is a good one. I mean, I got a lot of my philosophies as a manager from bumper stickers, and one of them that really stuck out was not what if, what now. You know, what if Kerry Wood was healthy? What if Mark Pryor had taken every start this year? What if Joe Borowski had not been hurt?
That's deep to right, and Brandt's giving up on it. It is way out of here for J.D. Clauser, off to a very slow start, but that's his first home run of the year, and the Rockies lead 2-0.
It's been a slow start for Clauser, but you can see why he was initially given the starter's job in the offseason. Switch hitter with power from both sides of the plate. He goes down and out over the plate and hooks that ball back to right field. That was a fastball outer third and down. That ball went way out of here.
Second career homer for Clauser. been some talk in the Denver papers that he may be close to heading back to AAA because of his struggles. That'll help his cause as far as staying here. 1-2 on the pitcher, Francis.
Yeah, those two run homers tend to help you stay in the big leagues. Of course, you have to hit a lot of them, but Clauser's always been a good hitter. He was a Diamondbacks farmhand when I was broadcasting for the team. Thought to have a bright future then, and thought to have a bright future this offseason with the Rockies, but it's been a struggle through the early going.
Two outs here in the second with Barmas coming up. Now the next time the Cubs are here, the interesting homestand starting on June 6th, the Toronto Blue Jays will come to Wrigley Field, followed by the Red Sox, and then the Florida Marlins. So that'll be a 9-game, 10-day homestand. Blue Jays right now 26-23, 4.5 out of the American League East. Burnett's under this one. Inning over. Clauser with his first home run of the year, a 2-run shot. And the Rockies have the early 2-0 lead.
Tonight at Red Roof Inn.
This is nice.
Steve stays in a renovated room.
Don't got much hair, but you got everything else.
And mixes business with pleasure.
Yes, sir. I'm working on those statistics right now.
Don't miss the redesigned, rededicated Red Roof Inn and Accor Hotel.
Days are running out for Hyundai's Race for the Record sales event, and your Hyundai dealers are out to set a record with deals like up to $2,500 cash back or 0% APR on select models, including the Hyundai Santa Fe, winner of Strategic Vision's 2004 Total Value Award. Day after day, Hyundai's award-winning quality lets us offer America's best warranty, 10 years, 100,000 miles. The race is on. Hurry to Hyundai's Race for the Record sales event for Memorial Day weekend at Hyundai. Get to your Chicagoland Hyundai dealer through Memorial Day weekend for up to $2,500 cash back or 0% APR.
Shining is giving someone a voice. With Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, you'll have the tools and flexibility to make the smartest decisions for you and your family. Because we believe your health care should stay right where it belongs, in your hands. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Illinois, shining through.
Tonight at Red Roof Inn, Bill stays in a business king room.
Look at this space.
And feels like a business king himself.
Multitasking.
Chances of me working are remote.
Don't miss the redesigned, rededicated Red Roof Inn and Accor Hotel.
Get a complete recap of the day in sports with Sports Night on Comcast Sportsnet. Coming up tonight at 6:30, Cubs and Sox highlights and the Indy 500. Watch Sports Night tonight at 6:30, only on Comcast Sportsnet. Not interested in Indy 500 highlights right now. Nap time.
Wake me up when the Cubs start scoring.
2-0 they trailed. Jason Dubois to deep left. And that'll one hop the wall. It's going to be a standing double for Jason Dubois.
First pitch hacking, but gets a pitch he's looking for. That fastball down and in. Jason, a very good low ball hitter. Went down and golfed that ball into left field. Good start here.
So a runner at second with nobody out. It's Jeremy Burnett who snapped an 0-for-14 yesterday. Went 1-for-4 with a run scored, hitting 167 on the homestand. Average right now at 263. Strike on Burnett's. Three hits here in the early going for the Cubs. Popped him up. Shallow center. Going out is Gonzalez to make the catch. Change the way you experience television with Sony's high-definition TV. Available at your local Sears store. We'd like to welcome all of our viewers watching on RCN Cable Channel 37 here in Chicago. Corey Patterson digging in, hitting 393 on the homestand with two home runs and a double. Curveball is low and outside. Jeff Francis throws a changeup, and he'll feature against right-handers. A lot of talk about the changeup at Coors Field. Joe Kennedy, for instance, dropped his curveball and uses a slider as his breaking pitch at Coors. But the bottom line, Bob, is really everyone's still trying to figure out how to do it at altitude.
And they've tried a lot of different approaches. We talked about it the other day. The Blake Street Bombers seem to be the team that had the most success playing at Coors Field. Just load up a lineup with home run hitters and let them go to hacking. That seemed to work pretty good. But as far as the pitchers, obviously breaking balls don't break the same in the thin air in Colorado as they do at sea level or some of the other venues around the major leagues. And breaking ball pitchers that have gone to Coors Field have struggled mightily. So it stands to reason that guys that throw hard and have good changeups might be better suited to pitch and be successful in Coors Field.
Well, one thing Dan O'Dowd is trying to do is develop pitchers. And I don't think you're going to see big free agent contracts handed out to pitchers after the Mike Hampton and Denny Nagel contracts. One to Patterson. That is fair. So DuBois will score easily. Here comes a throw from Hop. It's late. It's a standing two-base hit for the hot Corey Patterson. His second double on the homestand. Give him 19 RBIs on the year, and it's 2-1.
Good to see Corey drive in a run with something other than a home run. 10 home runs on the season, had only 18 RBIs coming into play today, but picks up Jason DuBois with a ringing double down into that right field corner.
So the Cubs coming back and getting one of those runs back. Michael Barrett with a runner in scoring position and one out. The other part of developing pitchers for the Rockies is that you get them at the big league level and their first experience is pitching at Coors Field. So they don't have a track record of pitching in, you know, pitcher friendly places before coming to Coors Field. Jason Jennings off to a good start in his career pitching at home. Talked about Jeff Francis at Coors Field. So you try to get him into that mix right off the bat. And you mentioned the other day Colorado Springs is their AAA affiliate, so they're already used to pitching at altitude.
You mentioned the two big free agent pitcher signings for the Rockies over the last number of years, Mike Hampton, Denny Nagel, and you can see why possibly those guys would be attractive to the Rockies. Hampton has always been a sinker ball pitcher, usually throws a lot of ground balls when things are going well. Nagel was a changeup pitcher. Unfortunately, he didn't really have enough fastball to make people respect it and lay off of that changeup.
2 to Barrett is hit high in the air behind second. Gonzalez out yet again to make the catch. Two away. A chance for Francis to get out of this inning with no further damage is Sergio Mitre. His career 105 average to the plate, 2 for 19.
He looked good in batting practice today, though. He was swinging it well.
Solid.
Yeah, solid.
Well, he's still seeking his first career RBI.
We've seen a lot of very off-balance lunging swings from the Cubs hitters today against Francis. That's a pretty good indication that he's got that changeup working well, getting the Cubs hitters off-balance, lunging at pitches. A lot of harmless pop-ups and fly balls.
Each team with four hits. Cubs with a run in here in the second. The Patterson RBI double scoring DuBois. 1-1. Bouncer to Relaford. He'll get it over to Helton in plenty of time. Cubs get a run on two hits. We'll head to the third. It's 2-1 Colorado.
It's go time. At Toyota's nationwide sales drive with phenomenal selection at every turn. There's great offers on some of our best models, like 1.9 financing or $700 cash on the 34 miles per gallon Camry. Or choose a great lease. And do yourself a favor, check out the luxurious Avalon, starting at around $28,000, and it gets 31 miles per gallon. Toyota's nationwide sales drive is on now. Owning the winner's circle. Now that's moving you forward.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs.
Doc Father, I need your help.
Go on, my friend.
I can't take it anymore. The high-pressure salespeople, the bad service, the low selection, the huge prices.
You've came to the right place. This I could help with.
Hi, I'm Andy Francis from Evergreen Kia, and we're always making deals you can't refuse. Like with a new Amante with $10,000 off, and that includes the Kia's 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. We're Evergreen Kia at 92nd and Western.
Take good care of my Kia.
And we'll take good care of you.
No money down. Some of the lowest monthly payments of the year. It's going on now at Team Saturn. Right now at Team Saturn, you can drive a brand new 2005 Saturn Ion 1 sedan for just $175 a month with no money down. Or a new 2005 Saturn View Sport. Plus, no money down, just $225 a month. These vehicles get great gas mileage, so you'll not only save on your payments, you'll save at the pump, too. No money down, low payments. This offer ends May 31st. Visit Team Saturn today.
Weekdays at noon, only on Comcast Sportsnet.
The Cubs and MBNA give you a chance to explore beautiful Wrigley Field. This 90-minute tour includes a clubhouse, field, dugouts, and much more. Tours are available on select dates from April to September, and all the proceeds benefit Cubs Care, a fund of the McCormick Tribune Foundation. Tickets are $20 and must be purchased in advance by visiting Cubs.com or by calling 1-800-THE-CUBS. The packed house today here at Wrigley. It's 2-1 Rockies as we start the third inning. Mitre working to Luis Gonzalez. He hits a first pitch deep to right. That's in the corner, and it is out into the basket for Luis Gonzalez. So his hitting streak now at 8 games. And it's 3-1. So two home runs for the Rockies here in the first three innings.
And Mitre has left a lot of pitches up in the strike zone and up above the strike zone. This time Gonzalez just with a little bit of a tardy swing, but gets that ball up in the air, the wind pushing it that direction, and just into the front row of seats down that right field line. That's something we didn't see from Mitre in his last start. Everything was down.
Perez charging, and he gets Todd Helton. Notice what Todd Helton has done today. He has gone right after that first pitch. Now he singled in his first at bat, but bounces out to Perez here in his second AB. I would think, I mean, we've talked so much about patience, Bob, but when you have a guy who's really patient and is really struggling, maybe in Todd Helton's case, he feels he needs to be more aggressive.
It's a never-ending battle. So it's all about adjustments. I mean, we've heard it a million times. It's just about making adjustments at the plate. And there are so many advanced scouts, so much video available now. You know, pitchers will watch hitters and see what they're doing. Are they attacking early in the count? If they are attacking early in the count, I'm not going to throw him a good pitch. Maybe I can get him to get himself out swinging at a borderline pitch. But if you take enough of those pitches and work some counts in your favor, then the advanced scouts will put that on the report. And consequently, pitchers will start being more aggressive again, throwing first pitch strikes, and it's just a back and forth process all season long.
2-1 on Wilson. Next pitch. And it's even at 2-2. Well, we got an email from Andy Howard in Auburn, Indiana. Question is, when a player is pressing at the plate, is there anything a manager can say, or does he just let it play out?
Stop pressing. Hey, you know, I think once again, it always depends on the individual. Some guys put a lot of pressure on themselves, just like we were talking about Sergio Mitre and his starts on the mound determining whether he's going to get another start. Well, with a young hitter, the same can be true. You feel like you have to get two hits every at bat just to stay in the lineup. And sometimes as a manager, you can tell the young man to relax. You're going to get 2 weeks of playing time and just go out there and show me what you can do. And hopefully they'll relax and go out and do what they're capable of doing.
3-2, and he walked him. That's the first walk issued by Mitre. And here's Brad Hopp, who was caught looking to end the first inning. Wilson with a good lead and took a step towards second, did not run. Patterson with the catch. Ball is tailing away from Corey as it came off the bat of the left-handed hitter. And a nice shoestring grab for the second out.
You're absolutely right. That ball coming off the bat of a left-hander, slicing away from Corey, but he got a great jump on it, stayed with it. Kept his glove open long enough for the ball to get into the pocket this time and makes a nice sliding catch on the grass.
Holiday with an infield hit and a run scored in the second. Will try to split this four-game series. It would be their second non-losing, as they put it, road series of the year. They split two at Philadelphia in April. Rockies will return home after this one. They'll open a 13-game homestand tomorrow night against the Cardinals. It's time these two teams will match up, the Cubs and the Rockies. It'll be at Coors Field. And it's a weekend series, three games, August 19th through the 21st. As William Jackson was talking on the pregame show, Dusty was saying, you know, these Southern California trips can sometimes be problematic with guys trying to get some extra pool time, and there's a lot to do in Los Angeles. Of course, you spent so much time in that division, probably no big deal to go to Los Angeles or San Diego, right?
Hey, you didn't want to be seen around town too much in L.A. when you were a member of the Giants. It was quite the rivalry out there on the West Coast, very similar to the Cubs and the Cardinals here in the Midwest, or the Yankees and the Red Sox back on the East Coast. And you didn't want to be recognized by those Dodger fans out on the streets.
Inside, full count, so Wilson will get a head start.
You know, another thing you ran into a lot of times was visiting teams that would come to the West Coast. It generally was a family trip, and a lot of wives and children along, and that was always an added distraction to the players when they came out to the West Coast.
Chicagoland Speedway upcoming schedule. 7-game trip coming up. Runner moving and a slicing fly ball down the right field line, and Burnett's with the catch. Nicely done by Bernie in foul ground to end the inning. Gonzalez with the leadoff home run. It's now 3-1. Jerry Hairston, his birthday today. He's 1-for-1. He'll lead it off when we come back.
Can I clear these for you? Okay, let me just F, D, M, D. I'll just take these out of your way, okay? Done? What about these? Are you guys done? Yeah, there we go.
Oh, you know what? That new busboy you hired, he's really working his butt off.
Yeah. I didn't hire a busboy.
This summer, grab some Coors or Coors Light. Look for specially marked packages for your chance to win never-released-before music downloads powered by Sony from Kinect.com. Taste the cold. Get the music.
Toyota talks about building the American machine, but the GMC Sierra 1500 Crew Cab has more standard V8 horsepower than Tundra, more torque, and better highway fuel efficiency. If you're going to talk about building a better truck, better back it up. Get $3,500 to $4,500 total cash back on select 2005 GMC Sierra 1500 Crew Cab vehicles in inventory. See the pros at your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana GMC dealers.
Americans are hardworking people, but they also treasure their free time. That's why most people have outdoor power equipment with high-performance Briggs & Stratton engines inside. They start easily and have the power to get the job done quickly. In fact, they've been helping Americans make the most of their free time for nearly a century. So be sure there's a powerful Briggs & Stratton engine inside. Briggs & Stratton, the power that works for you.
Fisher alongside William Jackson.
Today on the Early Sports Night, we'll take you live to the Brickyard. Josh Moore is there covering Danica Patrick in the Indy 500.
Plus big playoff games for the Russian Wolves at 6:30.
Tomorrow, don't miss a special best-of edition of Chicago Tribune Live. See some of the show's top moments as special guests and writers join Dan Jiggins to discuss all the hot topics. Best of Chicago Tribune Live tomorrow at 5:30 right here on Comcast Sportsnet. One strike on Jerry Hairston. 3-1 Rockies. On the ground, and a good pick by Desi Relaford. Seen some good defense from both sides here in the early going.
As you mentioned, middle infield positions in this series always has had very good hands, and third base much more of a reaction position. You could see he was playing up in front of the baseline, and just a dive to his left. Nice pick on the short hop and a strong throw across the infield.
Mayfield 0-for-1, fly to right in the first inning. Came in hitting in his last six straight at a 400 clip. And remember the big day he had right-handed on Friday against Joe Kennedy. Two-run double, two-run homer. So he likes to flex his muscles from the right side. Pitch and just missed. And he's run it full. It's 3-2 on Nafe with Derek Lee on deck. Derek is 6 for his last 7. Payoff pitch into left center for Nafe. Seven game hitting streak. And a runner on for D. Lee.
You know, we kind of joke about Nafe's power from the right side of the plate as opposed to the left side. 33 home runs in his career against left-handed pitching, which means he's batting right-handed. 25 homers when he bats left-handed, but he's done all the damage from the right side in less than half the at-bats that he has from the left side of the plate, so obviously that is his power side. Big, strong brute.
Here's a pitch to Lee. And way out in front and over top of a curveball.
We joke about it, but it is fun to watch in batting practice. You know, Nafe Perez, one of the smaller guys on the team, and he'll get up there in batting practice and knock a few balls up into the bleachers and slam his bat down and flex his biceps as he walks out of the batting cage. Always gets a rise out of his teammates.
The 0-1 is outside. Leads the National League in home runs. A-Rod leads the majors with 17. Long pause by Francis. Here he comes to the plate. Not so sure, but it's 1-2. Moise Salou with 5 home runs the last 10 days. Cubs with one steal today. That was Lee in the first inning. Jerry Hairston was picked off. Another throw. Francis really slowing things down here against Derek Lee with a runner at first. 1-2 pitch. And it's even.
As we mentioned at the top of the show, Francis' first start against the Cubs, and obviously the first opportunity they've had to see him up close and personal, and his delivery to the plate has moved to first base. Gary Matthews over there at first base keeping a real close eye on the Rockies left-hander, trying to find some trigger mechanism to let his runners know when to break for second base.
Tap foul on the ground near Chris Spire.
Once again, that's one of those things that with the advent of videotape and video scouting, you can break down a guy's delivery frame by frame, and sometimes there will be a difference between his delivery to the plate and his move to first that's easily detectable once you break down the videotape.
Took a little bit longer that time to head back to first. So a better move from Francis. He won 16 games at AA and AAA last year. His out to walk ratio was almost 7-1. No walks, no strikeouts early on today. Perez is running, and that one's fought off by Lee.
With two strikes on a hitter, you don't have the luxury of taking a pitch to allow that runner to steal the base. Nafe had a great jump at first base, but Derek Lee has got to protect that strike zone. Anything close with a two-strike count, he's got to be ready to swing at it, and that time fouled it away. Nafe probably would have stolen that base easily.
Count holding it 2-2 on Lee. Nafe not running. And it's 3-2. where he just gives you so many quality at bats. Even when he has made outs, for the most part, all year, he has made the pitcher work very hard. Here's the eighth pitch of the at bat. Base hit. Nathie around second. He'll end up at third. Derek, 2 for 2 today. 7 for his last 8.
And takes what Francis gives him. Fastball, actually a breaking ball up and out over the plate. Just goes with the pitch. You can see Gonzalez starting to cheat towards second base. Absolutely unnecessary right there. With a full count on the batter, you've got to hold your position and not worry about that base runner. Gonzalez moved a couple steps to his right, opened up enough of a hole for Derek Lee to shoot that ball into right field.
Rockies infield at double play depth against Ramirez, who lined to left. His first time up. Came in hitting 176 on his homestand, but he did hit a 2-run homer yesterday. Short lead by Lee at first. The pitch to Ramirez. Deep to left center. Holiday will have to chase it down. So Nathie's going to score. And Lee will be stopped by Chris Spire. It's 3-2. Ramirez with the run scoring double.
Another low pitch, very much like the one he lined out to left last at bat. This time he gets a little more of it, gets it over the head of Matt Holliday out into left center field. And only a good quick relay throw back into the infield held Derek Lee at third base right there.
So second and third. With only one out, Jason Dubois will be the batter. Bob Apodaca chatting with his battery. And Andy Fletcher heading out to break up the meeting. Again, this is the first time Jeff Francis has ever faced the Cubs. Watch live Cubs games right on your computer. Sign up for MLB.TV now exclusively at Cubs.com. MLB.TV means live baseball. Well, Jason Dubois jumped into the starting lineup on an everyday basis on May 10th. Since then, hitting .240 with 2 home runs, but the Cubs 10-4 in his last 14 starts. See the defensive alignment. Rockies will concede a run. Helton, not quite even with a bag, but in and played over towards second, the first base position, but everybody else is back. Two balls and a strike. Varmus and Hop are Rockies. Dubois right behind him. Rockies are going to put Dubois on now that it's 3-1. So they're loaded with Burnett's coming up.
You know, Len, since the injury to Mark Pryor, the Cubs offensively have really started to bunch the hits together. They've had some extended innings where they put two or three hits together with a walk and cashed in some runs, something that was sorely missing in the early part of this season, the ability to string together an offensive attack and really keep the pressure on the opposing pitcher in defense.
Bases full of Cubs for Burnett. It's 3-2 Rockies. One out here in the third inning. And the pitch on the ground. Helton bobbles. He'll get an out at first, but that's it. And the Cubs tie it. It's 3-3. RBI ground out for Burnett. Boy, at first it looked like it was going to be a double play easily. It took kind of a weird hop at the end. Helton with the brief bobble, and he was only able to get one out.
It won't be ruled an error because they did get an out at first base, but that's a play that Todd Helton makes as good as any first baseman in baseball, that 3-6-3 or 3-6-1 double play. That time just unable to find the handle cleanly, only could get the out at first base, tying the ball game up.
Patterson with an RBI double in the second. Second and third, two outs, two runs in to tie it. Popped him up. Barmas ends the inning. But the Cubs get two runs. On three hits, they strand two. It's 3-3 after three.
So you finally broke down and got it for him?
Yep.
How did he react?
Speechless.
Sony Grand Vega HD TV and digital cable with HD. The high def combination you've been waiting for. Now's the time. The Grand Vega HD TV, like no other.
Available at Sears.
Customize your Cobalt. Brought to you by your participating Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. Purchase or lease a 2005 Cobalt and get a $250 allowance towards GM accessories of your choice. Customize your Cobalt into a tenacious tuner. Plus, get a Cobalt base coupe or sedan for around $159 a month. Residency restrictions apply. Call for these details. Cobalt, the new commotion in the Chevy family. Join the revolution at your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers.
Pennzoil, with time-release molecules, delivers non-stop protection throughout the life of your oil. Not just oil, Pennzoil.
Get a $15 MasterCard gift card when you buy a case of Pennzoil Platinum Motor Oil at Murray's.
Hey everyone, I'm Josh Moore. On Monday, we've got a special holiday edition of Chicago Tribune Live. We look back at our visits with John Garland, Nomar Garciaparra, Layman Brewster, Bill Romanowski, and Colin Quinn. Join us Memorial Day at 5:30.
Well, let's check out today's Aflac trivia question. On this date in 1962, the Cubs hired the first African-American coach in baseball history. Can you name him? Get you the answer in the bottom of the fourth. We're in the top of the fourth. Desi Relliford, a switch hitter, leads off against Sergio Mitre. It's 3-3 from Wrigley. The 1-0 comebacker off the glove of Mitre. Hairston will bare hand and not make a throw. So Relliford with an infield hit. Well, everybody holds their breath when they see that now after what happened to Mark Pryor. Luckily for Mitre, it was a glove he got on it, not a body part.
You know, the good thing is no damage done. The bad thing is he slowed it down just enough that Jerry Hairston could not make the play at first.
This is the kind of situation that Ozzie Guillen was talking about last weekend. You talk about American League style of play versus the National League. You can be aggressive. You want to bunt a guy over, you can hit and run, whatever you want to do in the American League, but with the number seven hitter leading off with a hit, after Klossert's the pitcher. So it's just a completely different mindset here in the National League.
Joe Torre said it years ago, the difference between the American League and the National League was, in the National League as a manager, you try to make something happen before the pitcher spot gets up there. Of course, in the American League, you don't have that pitcher spot to worry about, so you can do pretty much anything you want as far as generating runs with the hit and run or stealing bases or bunting. But in the National League, you got that pitcher spot lurking down in that nine hole. You want to make something happen before you get to it.
Wasn't it a couple of years ago, 03, Jason Veritek hitting ninth for the Red Sox? Are you kidding me? The 2-0, swing and a miss, and it's 2-1. Of course, being a number 8 hitter in the National League is very different than being an 8 hitter in the AL. Pitchers are going to treat you a lot differently.
Well, most players will tell you that 8 spot is the toughest slot in the lineup to hit. Depending on game situation, the pitcher coming up behind you, or possibly a pinch hitter coming up behind you.
Runner moving, swing and a miss, and the throw is not in time. Safe is the call from Rob Drake. A good throw by Michael.
It looked like Relaford slid to the outside part of the base out there at second. You see Nafee comes up in front of the bag to make the catch, and by the time he sweeps that tag back there, Relaford was on the bag, then off the bag, then back on again. You see sliding to that very back corner of the base and able to get back on before Nafee can reapply the tag. He thought he got him the first time.
Two and two on Clauser. Came in slugging 190, but he had a 2-run homer in the second. Pitch. On the ground to Perez. Relaford ends up at third. A 6-3 ground out. But again, the pitcher coming up. Runner at third with one out. Looks like the Cubs are going to move their infield in, and Sergio Mitre might be thinking strikeout here against a guy who's now 1-for-20.
Yeah, a squeeze bunt always a possibility with a pitcher at the plate, especially a poor hitting pitcher. You figure he's got a better chance of putting the ball in play fairly on the ground by bunting it than he does swinging away.
He's 24. Does he look a day over 18 to you?
Not to me. He looks like a baby.
Everybody in, strike one. So one is low and away. Greg Maddux will start tomorrow night in Los Angeles against lefty Wilson Alvarez. 7 o'clock Central here on Comcast Sportsnet from Dodger Stadium. A couple of power arms on Tuesday night, Carlos Zambrano and Brad Penny. We check out tomorrow night. Greg Maddux will try to even up his record at 3-3. Alvarez making a second consecutive start, but probably won't stay in the Dodger rotation. They've shuffled things around lately.
It should be somewhat of an advantage for the Cubs seeing Alvarez tomorrow after facing Francis today. Very similar style of pitching. Both left-handers, both work away, throw changeups.
And he fouls it on the bunt attempt. But he is. Safety squeeze, because Relaford was not that far off third.
Of course, the difference, a suicide squeeze, that runner is coming as the pitcher delivers the ball to home plate. He's coming down that third baseline hard. On a safety squeeze, the runner has to see the ball on the ground and know that he can safely make it home.
Well, the Cubs will see three vastly different styles in that Dodgers series. The lefty Alvarez, then the power pitching Brad Penny, and then the sinker baller Derek Lowe on Wednesday night.
I think Brad Penny could be classified as a maximum effort pitcher. He grunts on every delivery, much like Nolan Ryan used to.
Another 2-2, it's full, 3-2. Seven pitches already from Mitre to Francis. Here he comes again. Ground ball. Relaford's going to stay at third. Perez to first. Two down. Wasn't easy, but Mitre able to get Jeff Francis on a weak ground out.
See the infield drawn into the edge of the grass. Little jam shot grounder right to Nathy Perez at short. Quick check on the runner. He knows Relaford's not going to go anywhere on a ball hit like that. And throws on to first in plenty of time to get the pitcher.
Strike one on Barmas. Missed Friday's game with a tweaked left ankle. Suffered on Thursday, but back in the lineup yesterday. And 0 for 3 with a walk yesterday. 0 for 2 to start today.
Armas has been solid in these situations this year, hitting 450 with two outs and runners in scoring position.
And two.
I like that word tweaked. You know, that's kind of a
catch-all, right?
Universally recognized quasi-medical term.
What happened? I tweaked it.
Tweaked it.
Mayfield again, charging. And he gets it. So Relaford left marooned at third. Midway in the fourth, it's 3-3.
I shall take the voice of this lovely woman.
This is Trump?
And put it into this damn head.
Why?
To tell the world the benefits of Aflac
with sex appeal.
Brilliant, sir.
I know. Now throw the switch.
If you're hurt and can't work, Aflac can help pay your bills with cash.
Genius! And her?
Aflac!
Where are Nigel and Trevor?
They're testing the vehicle stability control on the Lexus.
Any news?
The powerful allure of the RX, continuing to put the world on notice. See your Chicago area Lexus dealer.
Robert Morris College is one of the largest private colleges in the state. We awarded more bachelor's degrees in business management than any other private college in Illinois. A college that will test one's inner strength and create a competitive attitude where students design a path toward their future and turn their dreams into reality. It all leads to a collegiate experience that's like no other. Robert Morris College, real college for the real world.
Well, the Aflac trivia answer and the question on this date, 1962, Cubs hired the first African-American coach in baseball history. Can you name him? Buck O'Neill. Cubs coach from 62 to 65. So a photo from the archives, Buck O'Neill. 8-9-1 for the Cubs against the lefty Jeff Francis. It's 3-3, bottom of the fourth. Double A. Michael Barron, a very good stretch coming in over his last 23 games, just under 370. Tosser setting up on the inside. It is low and inside. Well, congratulations to Pete and Susie Toma. A great wedding last night. Awesome reception. Although you did not get out on the dance floor, I was a little disappointed not to see that. Although the video cameras were rolling, so it's probably a smart move as Barrett draws a leadoff walk here in the fourth. But a good time had by all, and they're a great couple. So congrats to Pete and Susie.
Absolutely. You know, bad knees. It's tough to get out there and dance and really do it the way I would like to do it. So I just don't do it at all.
And a pitch to Mitre, bunted out in front of the plate. Francis will get it to Gonzalez. Covering first, and a sacrifice for Sergio. So the Cubs will try to manufacture a run here in the fourth after the walk, the sacrifice bunt.
Nicely done. Just deadens that ball out in front of the plate. Get it out there far enough to keep it away from the catcher, but short enough that Todd Helton can't come charging in and get that lead runner at second. And the only play was Francis coming in and taking the out at first.
Hairston is one for two. And takes a strike. 28th time Jerry Hairston has led off for the Cubs this year. How about the on-base percentage as the leadoff hitter? Well, that's what you want to see coming into today at 378. Relaford, easy play. And Bruce Weber, Illinois basketball coach, will be up here a little bit later. Handle take me out to the ball game. Of course, he can let his players sing if he so chooses. And Kim Alexa, supermodel, is here at the ballpark as well today. That ring she was wearing, similar to the one Pete bought Susie. Nafy Perez hits one on the ground foul, so Pete has joined the fraternity.
Yeah, they're both round. Well, there were some dancing fools at that wedding last night. We weren't amongst them, but there were those who really showed some moves that I had never seen before.
Colleague Mark Brady might be a good choice. He's always the life of the party.
Even if there's no party going on.
The 0-1 to Nafy, fouled back to the netting.
Well, you'd really like to cash this run in, obviously, but you know, when you have the situation where your eight hitter gets on base, your pitcher bunts him into scoring position for the top of the order, those are the situations you'd really like to cash them in. Sometimes the opportunities just present themselves almost accidentally. This is one that was scripted perfectly.
And Nafy had to know he was going to get a good pitch to hit in this at bat with D. Lee on deck. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. So Lee will have to lead off the fifth for the Cubs. And it's still 3-3 from Wrigley.
This Memorial Day, feel free to drive a new Ford with 0% financing, zero payments all summer long, and zero maintenance for 2 years.
Are you really getting the best Hyundai deal? Hi, I'm Maury Edelson. Look at the value in a new Edelson Hyundai Sonata. First, the Edelson price. Then, America's best warranty with 10-year, 100,000-mile protection. And you save at the gas pump. You never pay additional freight charges or add-ons here. And get the best offer for your trade-in. Anyone can sell you a car. At Edelson Hyundai, we make customers for life.
Time to get up and make a trip to Military and Police Supply. So many things to see, so many things to buy, like canteens, jackets, Zippo lighters, boots and shoes, rings and patches, drink like a soldier, eat like one too. We're popular. You may have to circle for parking. Located at 7351 West Madison and Forest Park, minutes from the Eisenhower, from the city or suburbs, dial 312. Surplus for weekly specials and closeouts, serving you since 1977. Military and Police Supply. Now a few words from the drill instructor.
Every morning on Comcast SportsNet.
Well, let's meet today's Walgreens celebrity bat kids. Margaret Highball of Chicago, Ryan Kloon from Bannockburn. If you want to be a Walgreens celebrity bat kid, then send your name, age, address, phone number, and a parent or guardian signature to WGN Radio. Winners are selected at random. Entries will be accepted until August 29th. Good luck. It's 3-3 as we start the fifth inning today. Cubs have won the last two. This is game four of this series. Luis Gonzalez with a leadoff homer in the third inning off Sergio Mitre, who has yet to work a 1-2-3 inning. Sergio at Triple-A went 3-0 with a 0.95 ERA at home. And was 0-4 with a 7.27 earned run average on the road. Of course, coming off a solid outing here at Wrigley, his first major league start this year. So he has been a lot more comfortable in the home uniform this year. In tight, 3-1. Two and five in his big league career with a 6.42 ERA. This is his 17th major league appearance and his 13th start. Ground ball, Nathy Perez, who's been busy lately. 5th 6-3 ground out the last two innings for Mitre.
It's such a big out to get that leadoff hitter, especially with Todd Helton, Preston Wilson coming up behind him. It allows your defense to play in a straight up position where they can plug as many holes as possible. Let that leadoff man get on and give Todd Helton a hole to shoot at. He'll pick a pitch and try to hook one through that hole in the right side. But Derek Lee now playing with his heels against the outfield grass, covering a lot of ground.
Hey, guess who? It's Nafee again.
He's our featured defender today, much like Todd Helton has been at first base throughout this entire series. 6-3 unassisted putouts in the first game of this series. A couple in each subsequent game, and for the Cubs, Nafee's the man today.
5 straight ground balls to short. Preston Wilson's had a very nice series. He has 5 hits in the series, 5 for 10. Time to get up. It's a fifth inning. Now, give me some more time.
Just changing positions. Had to fluff up the pillow that is Dad's shoulder.
You saw Wilson kind of turn the other way, kind of selling it that it was inside to Andy Fletcher. Barrett wants it down. But this one will get out. I was just going to say he better keep it down because Wilson's really locked in, and it's 4-3. third home run for the Rockies today.
Somebody out there on Waveland has a tremendous throwing arm. That ball came all the way back into Aramis Ramirez at third base.
Well, that ball was crushed by Preston Wilson.
He's such a good low ball hitter. You got to go down lower than low.
Pop is 0 for 2.
I mean, this is a two iron shot. Great extension on a low pitch. A little creativity on the home run trot there. Not to mention on his eye black. I wasn't going to say anything about it, but after a trot like that, I've got to point it out.
The ground ball out. Preston Wilson with the home run, his third of the series. Derek Lee, his former Marlin teammate, red hot, 2 for 2 today. And he'll lead it off for the Cubs when we come back.
What I seek every single day is perfection. I want you to guess how many checks we process each day. Try more than 40 million, more than any other company in America. But what's truly impressive is the accuracy with which we take care of them. I'm Lance Drummond, I'm a banker, and I'm proud to be part of Bank of America. If you weren't a perfectionist, you couldn't do this job. One error in a million is simply unacceptable. So at Bank of America, we customize our own equipment. We engineer our own software, create our own quality control systems. To us, this is like an assembly line that is mission critical, meaning zero defects. This isn't about processing nearly 11 billion checks a year flawlessly. It's a matter of accurately handling one single check and then repeating it 11 billion times.
Bank of America, higher standards.
One car has factory-installed keyless remote start, and it's not a Honda Accord. Only one car has the first and largest four-panel panoramic roof available, and it's not a Toyota Camry. And it's not a Nissan Altima 2.5 that has the most powerful engine. It's the first ever Pontiac G6. With hot-button bonus cash and available cash back, the first ever G6 starts around 19.8. Hot-button bonus cash on all Pontiac models ends May 31st.
Time now for the Pontiac Sports Night Update.
Mitch Robinson in our Chicago studios. While the Cubs are losing players, looks like the White Sox will get Frank Thomas back tomorrow. He hit 190 in 42 at-bats down in AAA, but Big Frank says he's ready to go. Sox are home against the Angels tomorrow. Much more on Sports Night at 6:30, but now back to Len Casper and Bob Brenly.
All right, thank you, Mitch. Bottom of the fifth, and it's now 4-3 Rockies after the Preston Wilson solo home run. Two balls, no strikes on Derek Lee. He's 2 for 2 today, 7 for his last 8, with 4 home runs. 3-0. Francis has not given him anything attractive here in the first 3 pitches. That's a strike, 3-1. He wants this one down. Wasn't down, but just outside. I have a question for you, Professor Brenly. Do you think in general, not talking about Jeff Francis or Sergio Mitre, but young pitchers in general today, if they are told pitch around this guy, don't walk him, but don't give him anything to hit, do you think most pitchers are really able to do that like pitchers used to be able to do that?
I don't think young pitchers are. I don't think they've really been instructed. Of course, there are always exceptions.
Ramirez with a laser. Cubs lead. Francis walked Lee, and Ramirez made him pay. Rammy's starting to heat up.
Boy, that's a great sign, obviously, for the Cubs offensively, not only to get him going, with that bat hot, but that's going to guarantee that Derek Lee gets more good pitches to hit, and it just snowballs up and down the lineup. Boy, just a nothing ball inside part of the plate. A little stylish bat toss there of his own. And a rocket line drive home run.
So it's 5-4.
Hey, you know, getting back to your question, I think a lot of times when you tell a young pitcher, pitch around this guy, we don't care if we walk him, they immediately throw all breaking balls. When you pitch around a hitter, you should throw the pitch that you have the best command of, the pitch that you know more often than not you can put in the spot you want. And generally, that's a fastball. But a lot of times you'll go out and tell a young pitcher, hey, we don't care if we walk this guy, pitch around him, and they want to throw four breaking balls and hang one of them, and the ball gets whacked up in the seats.
Boy strikes out. Second strikeout for Francis.
I mean, we saw Francis there with Derek Lee, and it was obvious he was pitching around him, and he threw fastballs off the plate. He kept everything away and down, other than the 3-0 pitch, which was right down the middle of the plate, but threw all fastballs, a pitch that he felt he could command the best.
And it's the batter with one out. Look, there are a lot of guys against whom you can use their aggressiveness, you know, against them and get them to chase bad pitches. Marcos Carvajal, a righty. Derek Lee is not one of those guys. And you and I have seen so many situations over and over and over again where teams will try to get him to chase something, and he just will not do it. We've seen Billy Wagner make a huge mistake on a 3-1 pitch. Young Kim not happy with the pitch he made yesterday.
I mean, the most obvious guy that jumps to mind is Barry Bonds. You cannot pitch around Barry Bonds. He won't swing at a bad pitch, and number two, umpires won't call borderline pitches on Barry.
And to left center for Burnett. Makes the big turn. He's going to hold with a single. 9 hits for the Cubs.
Burnett going with the pitch the other way. Falls right on the outside corner. That's actually a pretty good pitcher's pitch right there. Burnett still able to get the head of the bat on the ball and line it into the gap in left center.
So the Cubs averaging right now 10 hits per game the last 3 days. 11 hits Friday, 10 yesterday, 9 today. Strike on Patterson. Good location, outside corner. Ramirez giving the Cubs their first advantage today with a 2-run homer. Well, 2 pitches in just a perfect spot. Right-hander Roberto Lavoa called up yesterday with Pryor going on the DL. He's getting loose.
As we sneak up on that 9 spot, this is what we were talking about earlier, the number 8 hitter. This is a situation where you're probably going to see a pinch hitter should Michael Baird get up to the plate this inning. See a pinch hitter in that 9 spot.
Holiday under it makes a catch.
So now this at bat is considerably different than the at bat Michael had, say, back in the second inning when he knew Mitre was going to hit behind him. Well, now there's a possibility there'll be a pinch hitter in that on deck circle. That's going to change Michael's approach at the plate.
Burnett's at first with 2 outs. An email from Scott in Anamosa, Iowa, and he writes, Bob, I was just wondering if you ever played for the Cedar Rapids Giants. Now they're called the Cedar Rapids Colonels. If you ever get a chance to come to Cedar Rapids, Iowa, you can check out the new ballpark. It is really nice.
I like the old ballpark in Cedar Rapids. That was one of the best minor league stadiums I ever played in. And I played there in 1977 as a member of the Cedar Rapids Giants.
22 home runs.
Yeah, big ballpark too.
Midwest League MVP that year.
Probably Paul Molitor.
He was.
He didn't sign till June, played half a season, and was the most valuable player in the league. Kind of a premonition of things to come.
The Burlington Bees.
Yes, indeed. Dennis Menke was their manager, former big league player. Boy, those were the days. He'd live on sweet corn for weeks at a time. Some of the farmers would bring in big grocery sacks full of sweet corn, and on the minor league salary that we were making back in the day, we lived on corn. It's appropriate they're the Colonels now.
Right. That's a fun league. A lot of great ballparks in the Midwest League. Kane County, up in Appleton, Wisconsin. Either the Timber Rattlers. In the hole, Barmas backhands. He will get the force play at second to end the inning. But the Cubs now lead for the first time today. Aramis Ramirez with his ninth home run of the season. Got out in a hurry. Two-run shot. And it's now 5-4 Cubs.
Americans are hardworking people, but they also treasure their free time. That's why most people have outdoor power equipment with high-performance Briggs & Stratton engines inside. They start easily and have the power to get the job done quickly. In fact, they've been helping Americans make the most of their free time for nearly a century. So be sure there's a powerful Briggs & Stratton engine inside. Briggs & Stratton, the power that works for you.
Rugged design. Awesome power. The freshest truck line of any manufacturer. This is Nissan Now. Now get $2,000 cash back or 2% financing for 36 months on the full-size V8 Nissan Titan. This is the Nissan Now sales event. Hurry, offers end May 31st.
I hear that you guarantee all your work. Is that true?
Yes.
Can you have our van ready in time for the canoe trip this afternoon?
Absolutely.
Are your 3,000 certified mechanics guided by the ideals of the young Voyagers? He's one of us!
Visit Midas and get brake pads or shoes for $39.95, plus installation. We'll provide a written estimate for installation and fully explain any additional work needed. For mechanics known for their work and their word,
trust the Midas touch.
Cubs fans, come early and save big with the Cubs Early Bird Discount. During the first hour, the gates are open. Enjoy 25% off all food and non-alcoholic beverages. For hot dogs, pizza, Pepsi, and more, catch the Cubs Early Bird Discount.
Don't pass up your opportunity to experience a Cubs game from one of the official rooftop partners across the street from Wrigley. For information, visit ballparkrooftops.com. 5-4 Cubs. Aramis Ramirez with a two-run homer, giving the Cubs the lead for the first time today. Sixth inning, it's Matt Holliday, busted his bat. Ground ball, Nathy Perez moving to his left and throwing out Holliday. So Mitre continues to get a bunch of ground ball outs, just over 80 pitches here into the sixth inning. Eight ground balls to Nathy Perez. Relaford 1-for-2 with a stolen base. Frank Thomas will be activated from the DL tomorrow. So he'll be available to play for the first time since left ankle surgery in the offseason. 11 games on a rehab assignment. Nathy unable to get to that ground ball, and Relaford has his second hit today. You know, I've heard people talk about, well, what's it going to be like when Frank comes back and the chemistry and all that. I'll take Frank Thomas on my team, especially if I'm in the American League and he can DH.
Of course, the question is, will it be the Frank Thomas of old, the guy much like Derek Lee right now that works deep counts, takes his walks, hits the ball out of the ballpark with regularity, or will it be a Frank Thomas that struggles, has trouble running the bases, We'll have to wait and see, but you're absolutely right. Frank Thomas in his prime, as good as they come as an offensive player, especially in that DH slot.
Breaker for a strike on Clauser, who hit a two-run homer, his first of the year in the second inning.
He was just a little bigger, you know, he's just not big enough.
The Rockies have a pinch hitter on deck for Francis, Dustin Moore. Had a couple of doubles yesterday.
I got my fill of Frank Thomas in spring training with the Arizona Diamondbacks. Of course, the Rockies share, or rather, the White Sox share the facility down in Tucson, Electric Park, and seemed like we played the White Sox every other day in spring training. And I saw plenty of Frank. A lot more than I would have liked.
Two-one with Relaford running, and a perfect hit run, almost hit. In fact, Relaford, he was able to just get out of the way, and he makes a big turn at third. He's going to hold. Barrett goes and gets the throw, and they're at the corners. Boy, that hot shot almost hit Desi Relaford. If it had hit him, he would have been out.
Able to hurtle over that hard ground ball into right field, and then regather his momentum. Goes hard between second and third base and had ideas about trying to score as that ball got into the thick outfield grass and just died.
Here comes Dusty. So that'll be it for Sergio Mitre. It's time for the Ford call to the pen. First and third, one out, Cubs leading by one. Novoa will pitch when we come back.
Time-release molecules delivers non-stop protection throughout the life of your oil. Not just oil, Pennzoil.
Get a $15 MasterCard gift card when you buy a case of Pennzoil Platinum Motor Oil at Murray's.
Night.
Night.
Oh, Steven, let's not forget to touch base with the West Coast.
Okay.
Oh, and Steven, we need to get that SRP report out first thing tomorrow.
Okay.
Yeah. Gonna have a pretty late night myself.
Everything you want, every time you visit, including free long distance and high-speed internet when you join Wyndham by request.
Customize your Cobalt. Brought to you by your participating Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. Purchase or lease a 2005 Cobalt and get a $250 allowance towards GM accessories of your choice. Customize your Cobalt into a tenacious tuner. Plus, get a Cobalt base coupe or sedan for around $159 a month. Residency restrictions apply. Call for these details. Cobalt, the new commotion in the Chevy family. Join the revolution at your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers.
Roberto Novoa in his second stint with the Cubs big league club this year. 1-1 with three saves and a 2.78 ERA and two stints at AAA. And a big spot here. Cubs right now with a one-run lead. But the Rockies have them at first and third with one out, and it's a pinch hitter, Dustin Moore. Cubs want a double play here. Ball one.
Moore got a start in right field yesterday, had a couple of doubles his first two times up in the ball game.
Upstairs, two balls, no strikes. Relaford, the tying run at third. J.D. Clauser is at first.
Ball
largest home crowd of the year, 40,322 here at Wrigley on this cloudy and overcast but pleasant Sunday afternoon, Memorial Day weekend. Final game of a 10-game homestand. Strike, 2-2. Southpaw Will Ullman. I figure Will Ullman is getting ready just in case Todd Helton comes up later in this inning. Unless the Cubs hoping that doesn't happen. He's still about four batters away. Base is loaded. Boa walks more.
All fastballs that at bat to Dustin Moore. Noboa misses with a fastball away, then he misses with a fastball up. A real good quality strike right there on the 2-0 pitch, right at the knees. Another one at the knees, then he overthrows that pitch to run the count to full, and then misses up high with another fastball.
Clint Barmas pops it up. Infield fly rule, and it's caught by Hairston. Umpires can call for the infield fly even if that infielders in the outfield grass, and with the bases loaded, that's exactly what happened. Two outs. And Barmas is 0 for 4. So it's up to Gonzalez as Noboa tries to get out of it. Front of Burnett's, one run in, another one headed toward the plate. The throw bobbled by Barrett, and Clauser's safe. Michael just could not find the handle, and the Rockies take the lead again at 6-5. So Gonzalez gets it done with a two out, two run single.
Not only good hitting by Gonzalez, but smart hitting by Gonzalez. With runners in scoring position, most pitchers are going to go away from a hitter's strength. Gonzalez looked out over the plate. You could see Michael Barrett had the ball in plenty of time, but just couldn't come up with it. Hit off the edge of that big catcher's mitt, did not get into the pocket of the glove. He never had command of it, and Clauser with a nice backdoor slide there to get his hand on the plate.
Todd Helton will be intentionally walked to load him up again, and Preston Wilson on deck. So a seesaw affair here at Wrigley today, 6-5 Rockies. So the choice here really came down because Will Ullman is ready for Dusty Baker. Would you rather have Will Ullman facing Todd Helton with first base open, or Noboa against Wilson with the bases loaded?
And I'm sure right now that wasn't an easy decision for Dusty. Todd Helton has not been swinging the bat well in this series. Preston Wilson has been red hot.
A 3-1 pitch for a home run in the fifth inning. Swing and a miss. Two strikes. He went around as Bob Davidson. That ends the inning. The Rockies get two on the Luis Gonzalez single. Cubs will bat in the bottom of the sixth. They're trailing once again by a run.
Welcome to California.
We run.
We rip.
We fly.
We swing.
We believe.
We believe in Nirvana.
We rock!
And we've got our own motto.
So come on. Come on.
Come on.
Listen to my wife.
Find yourself in California. Fly Southwest Airlines' new nonstop service from Chicago Midway to San Jose for just $84 one way.
You are now free to move about the country.
Gail Fisher alongside William Jackson.
Today on the Early Sports Night, we'll take you live to the Brickyard. Josh Moore is there covering Danica Patrick in the Indy 500.
Plus big playoff games for the Russian Wolves at 6:30.
It's amazing what people can do when they're confident in their equipment. You think about that. Then you build a range of turbocharged performance sedans with legendary Volvo safety. The 2005 Volvo S60s.
Some cars are just born to follow, one-dimensional, charisma-free. But this car has a different vibe. It takes any road you throw at it and everything you throw in it. Runs fast between lights and long between fill-ups. Give it a destination and go where the vibe takes you. With available cash back and hot-button bonus cash, a new vibe starts around $15,700. Non-GM owners and lessees get a new vibe for around $14,700. Hot-button bonus cash on all Pontiac models ends May 31st.
Weekdays at noon, only on Comcast SportsNet.
After the game, stick around for Cubs Post Game Live, presented by Joe's Crab Shack. Get highlights of all the action, analysis from Dan Plesac, plus hear what Dusty Baker has to say during his postgame news conference. Don't miss Cubs Post Game Live, immediately following the game right here on Comcast SportsNet. Marcos Carvajal, a right-hander, is on for the Rockies. Jeff Francis went five innings, allowed five runs on nine hits. This half inning of Cubs baseball brought to you by Robert Morris College, real college for the real world. And Enrique Wilson, the pinch hitter. That's another reason why Dusty Baker wanted Roberto Novoa to finish the sixth inning. He didn't want to have to double switch with the pitcher's spot leading off the bottom of this inning. And that's a factor probably more so in the sixth inning than it would be in the eighth or ninth. You want to save your bench guys as much as you can and your bullpen.
Especially in a seesaw ball game like this, you want to make sure you have the right guys available for those pinch hitting slots late in the ball game. Any defensive substitutions that you may want to make late in the game if you have a lead. If you burn those guys early in the ball game as pinch hitters, obviously they're not available late. And sometimes that'll determine the pitcher that you bring into the ball game. If you have a pitcher that you want to go more than one inning, then you're going to have to make a double switch if his spot is scheduled to lead off the next inning. In the case of Novoa, Dusty just wanted him to get out of that inning.
Called strike three for the first out.
Wilson doesn't think so. Andy Fletcher does, and he's really the only opinion that matters back there. A very fluid strike zone today. It's kind of moved around from time to time early in the game. A lot of very low pitches called strikes. A couple of high strikes through the middle going. See what kind of strike zone we have here at the end of the ball game.
Right-hander Joe Borowski. And nothing on Hairston. Almost hit him on a fastball. Rode inside. 3-0. And And most games you can kind of get a handle on. This one's been tough. It's just kind of gone all over the place. Both offenses have been good today. Cubs have had one lead, but it was brief.
Cubs have had opportunities. They've left at least one runner on base every inning through the first five, including two men left on in the third when they were able to score two runs. Still left the bases, well, left two guys on base.
And Hairston with a one out walk. It'll bring up Nafe, who is 1-for-3 with a run scored today. University of Illinois men's basketball team will soon take me out to the ball game coming up in the middle of the seventh.
Sure, that'll be one of the tallest versions of the seventh inning stretch we'll hear all year.
Nafe batting left-handed for the first time today. At Milwaukee 2-0 middle of the eighth at Miller Park. Nationals 3-2 after 6 at Busch Stadium. There goes Hairston. That one is bounced in the hole and in the right to Jerry, who took a look at it, will end up at third. A beautifully executed hit and run for the Cubs. Well, we saw the Rockies do it in the top of this inning.
See Hairston on the move at the top of your screen. Helton came off the bag, but not far enough to make a play. Gonzalez can't get there with the slide. Perfectly executed. First and third. Get on the merry-go-round.
And the pitching coach is coming out again. Derek Lee probably leads the league in having pitching coaches head to the mound before his at-bats. And you can understand why. He's reached all three times today. He's had a huge series.
Bob Apodaca with the slow walk. He's probably trying to think, what in the heck can I say when I get out here? Jeez, you know, everything we throw this guy, he hits hard somewhere. I'll think of something by the time I get there.
You think he's telling him don't walk him, but don't give him anything to hit? We discussed earlier, as you saw Jose Acevedo start to get loose. But going back to your point in the fifth inning, you know, Ramirez with a double, a home run, and three RBIs today. So it's not as if you just want to give a free pass to Lee and go after Ramirez.
That's so important. You hear guys talk about protection in the batting order all the time. It doesn't really matter so much who it is. It's just how they are swinging the bat at that particular time. And with the way Aramis has been swinging the bat in this series, you can bet he's gotten the attention of the Rockies coaching staff and pitching staff.
Good chance for the Cubs here, down by a run. Curveball outside. Hairston walked with one out. And on a hit and run, Nafe moved him to third with a single to right. Fastball 2-0.
Carvajal has unleashed three wild pitches this year and only 18 plus innings of work. So if they are going to pitch around Derek Lee, always a possibility he throws one right by his catcher.
Well, every time he swings now, you hear the crowd here at Wrigley say, ooh.
The Carvajal got away with a hanger right there. Just a nothing breaking ball. Let her high out over the plate. Big swing from Derek Lee.
2-1 to Lee in the center. Tie game as Hairston trots home. He is 3-for-3 today. That's his 46th RBI, and it's 6-6.
Fastball belt high out over the plate. Derek Lee goes right back up the middle of the field with it. I'll tell you, in a very perverted kind of a way, actually a good job by Carbajal to keep him in the ballpark right there. As hot as Derek Lee has been, that's a pitch that we've seen him hit out of here into the bushes in center field.
First and second for Ramirez. Cubs have tied it again. Outside, one ball, one strike. Well, the out he made was in the first inning. A frozen rope to left. On the right field line, slicing toward the seats. Just out of play. Cardinals are down in the seventh as we check out the two-run homer in the fifth inning. He knew it. His ninth homer of the year. Mentioned the Cardinals are down today. They have won five in a row. Cubs coming into today in third place, 8.5 out in the National League Central. The ball will throw to second. But at this point in the season and the way things have gone for the Cubs, they're not worried about anybody else. Just trying to pile up some wins, get to 500 today, and that would be a start. Kids ready for action today. Here comes Carbajal. Full count.
Well, you may see the runners on the move here. The way Ramirez has been swinging the bat today, looks pretty locked in, putting the ball in play hard every at bat. Better than average speed at first and second base here for the Cubs. Maybe a good opportunity to get the runners going. And if Ramirez would happen to hit a ground ball right at somebody, you stay out of the double play and the inning would continue for Jason DuBois.
They are running, hit hard, and throw. Cubs will get the lead again as Perez scores. Lead a third. It's 7-6, and Ramirez with his third hit today. He has knocked in four on the afternoon.
Another good approach from Aramis. Ramirez going right back up the middle of the field. Doesn't try to pull the ball. Just takes what is given to him and actually hits it right by Luis Gonzalez at second base, who was in pretty good defensive position, just couldn't come up with that hard hit ball.
Ford called to the pen. Jose Acevedo will make his entrance. 7-6 Cubs in the sixth.
This is Carol. She's been called hippie, preppy, yuppie, protester, Democrat, Republican, mom, CFO, CEO, cancer patient, cancer survivor, fundraiser, spokesperson, caregiver, and soon to be world traveler. Reaching retirement is no small achievement. We'll help you make the most of it. Introducing Fidelity Retirement Income Advantage. Before you retire, call today for a free retirement income planning consultation at 800-FIDELITY.
Night.
Night.
Oh, Steven, let's not forget to touch base with the West Coast. Oh, and Steven, we need to get that SRP report out first thing tomorrow.
Okay.
Yeah, gonna have a pretty late night myself.
Everything you want, every time you visit, including free long distance and high-speed internet when you join Wyndham by request.
This Memorial Day, feel free to drive a new Ford with 0% financing, zero payments all summer long, and zero maintenance for 2 years.
Well, the Cubs with the lead once again. A right-hander, Jose Acevedo, will face Jason Dubois. The Cubs would like to stretch their lead here. They have them at the corners. Still only one out, three straight singles in this inning, two runs in. And a 7-6 lead. Popped him up and everybody will have to hold as Varmus makes a catch. So Dubois pops out and that'll bring up Burnett. Neither team has led by more than two runs. Cubs have not led by more than one run. This is their second lead today. Pitch to Burnett is a strike. Acevedo was acquired from the Cincinnati Reds in April.
The third hit for Jeremy Burnett in 13 at-bats against Acevedo, all three of them home runs. This one an opposite field blast, giving the Cubs a little bit of breathing room here in this seesaw battle.
Great catch out there on the bleachers. Five runs here in the sixth inning. So Ramirez and Burnett each with four RBIs today. I mean, the thing you love about it is Derek Lee is 3-for-3 with a walk and RBI, three runs, stolen base as well, but he isn't the big story today. And that's good news for the Cubs, that it's some other guys pitching in big time.
Well, one of our keys to the game was follow Derek's lead. And certainly the Cubs offensively have done that today, especially Aramis Ramirez. Now Jeremy Burnett with a big three-run homer. Nathan Perez has been very busy again today. Spread the wealth.
High in the air off the bat of Patterson. And caught by Varmus. The 11th three-run homer for the Cubs this year. Burnett goes Papa. Three-run shot. Lead is now four.
Coors Light. Taste the cold.
Days are running out for Hyundai's Race for the Record sales event, and your Hyundai dealers are out to set a record with deals like up to $2,500 cash back or 0% APR on select models, including the Hyundai Santa Fe, winner of Strategic Vision's 2004 Total Value Award. Day after day, Hyundai's award-winning quality lets us offer America's best warranty, 10 years, 100,000 miles. The race is on. Hurry to Hyundai's Race for the Record sales event for Memorial Day weekend at Hyundai. Get to your Chicagoland Hyundai dealer for Memorial Day weekend for up to $2,500 cash back or 0% APR.
Salmon spend most of their adult lives in the ocean. After maturing, they migrate back to spawn in the same rivers and streams where they were born. It is here that many a salmon's life is cut short. However, there is good news. I just saved a bunch of money on my car insurance by switching to Geico.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Tomorrow, the Cubs hit the road to Southern California for a showdown with the Los Angeles Dodgers, followed by Cubs postgame live. Cubs-Dodgers, tomorrow night at 7. Get your game on Comcast SportsNet.
Well, on Friday, June 10th, the first 20,000 fans will receive a scratch-and-win card. 100 random winners will be taking home a majestic 2005 Nomar home jersey, compliments of MBNA. Fans are encouraged to hold on to their cards for second chance drawings throughout the game, and for complete rules, visit Cubs.com. It is now 10-6. The Cubs with five big ones in the sixth inning. And Joe Borowski making his third appearance of the year. And this is the first time he has pitched with the Cubs leading. Facing Brad Hopp. And Borowski would have been in even if it had been a one-run lead. But now it's four after the three-run homer by Burnett. When you think about the two homers today for the Cubs, Ramirez and Burnett, no doubt about either of them. Both hit very well. Called strike three.
Borowski, the fastball right down the middle of the plate, just freezing the Rockies left-handed hitter. Joe did a great job on his rehab assignment. In seven ball games, he held the opposition to a 107 batting average. Really, the only question was he going to get enough pitches in down there? His first couple of outings, he was under 10 pitches in his inning of work.
No pitch to Holiday. That one off Michael Barrett. So again, the Illinois men's basketball team all the way to the finals this year, and I'm going to sing Take Me Out to the Ball Game. How did you put it? The tallest version?
The tallest version we will hear this year.
And knocked down by Ramirez, but Holiday is going to reach.
Ball hit too hard for Ramirez to really do much else but try to play it on the backhand side. It hits off the heel of his glove, just climbs right up his arm, and ricochets over towards Nathan Perez at short.
It is a hit for Holiday. And we're not saying these guys are that tall, but they can see Lake Michigan from field level. Strike to Relaford.
Yeah, they can wade out there about 200 yards and still not be underwater.
Mitre started, went 5 1/3, 9 hits. And let's count them up here. All 6 runs, because the Novoa. He allowed the single to Gonzalez. Those runs were charged to Sergio. has been a hitter's day here at Wrigley. Runner moving. Here's a throw by Barrett. And safe at second is Holiday. So the Rockies remaining aggressive even though they're down four.
Yeah, nothing really Michael Barrett could do about that. Holiday had a walking lead over there at first base. Borowski didn't pay enough attention to him. Michael puts a pretty good throw down there, and you can see the runner is going to be safe even if Nafee holds on to that ball. That's a mark of a Clint Hurdle team. They stay aggressive even when they've been behind by a lot of runs. Of course, I think a lot of that is a byproduct of playing at Coors Field, where you can never score enough runs.
Husky's pitch. 3-2. Jay Witosik is up for the Rockies. Borowski with 33 saves in 0-3. He had 9 last year before succumbing to the shoulder problems. And he was shut down in June, did not pitch again. He struck him out, so 2 K's in the inning for Borowski.
Struck him out on a bad breaking ball, a hanging slider about shoulder high. Relaford immediately knows that was a pitch he should have laid off of right there, but good for Joe Borowski to get the swinging strike, trying to strand Holiday out there at second base. And once again, we come up with another one of the situations with the 8 hitter at the plate. Pinch hitter on deck. It's going to change your approach. When you know you have another hitter coming up behind you, you can be a little more selective at the plate. Take a walk if the pitcher won't give you anything to hit because you know you have another offensive player coming up behind you.
One, a bouncer foul as Dave Collins, Rockies first base coach. Dave Collins stole 79 bases in 1980. That was good enough for third in the National League. Win the title every year now. The Cubs thought that was strike three, but the only opinion that mattered was Andy Fletcher's. Corey Sullivan, the pinch hitter on deck. Two from Borowski. This one's fair, and Lee will step on first. Seventh inning stretch time.
For Take Me Out to the Ball Game, the University of Illinois men's basketball team.
Here we go, Chicago, up on the line, our fans. 1, 2, 3. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and cracker jacks. I don't care if I ever get back for this group.
Cobalt has more standard horsepower than the Toyota Corolla or Honda Civic and a 5-year, 60,000-mile powertrain warranty. The all-new Chevy Cobalt.
Use hot button bonus to lease an 05 Cobalt coupe or sedan for around $159 a month. Residency restrictions apply. Call for details. See your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers.
Is there anything else I can bring you? supposed to be back at the office at 2, sir.
Yeah, sir, the job's taking longer than I expected.
Shh.
I can't rush perfection.
We'll just try.
Will do, sir.
He bought it.
Try takeout. All the fun and all the flavor at home.
Chicago Tribune Live, the sports show that's got the whole town talking.
He might be the worst professional athlete to ever play in this town.
Weeknights at 5:30 on Comcast Sportsnet.
Bottom of the seventh, the Cubs lead the Rockies 10-6. Been an offensive day here at Wrigley Field. Great job by the Illinois men's basketball team. And the coach, Bruce Weber, is with us now. You let the players sing, and you're going to do the interview. Is that how it works?
That's how it works. I'm the big guy. I can tell them what to do. And I embarrassed myself 2 years ago when I sang by myself. I'm never going to do it ever again.
It's Michael Barrett to lead it off against right-hander Jose Acevedo. Well, Coach, congratulations on a great season and a great late comeback. Just fell a little bit short in the championship game, but it was a great run.
It was. I mean, you're talking 37 wins, Big Ten championship, Big Ten tournament champ, Final Four championship game. There's not much more you can do. And just couldn't get a shot down against Carolina, against a team that's very, very good. You're talking 5-6 guys that, from the Carolina team that may be drafted.
Barrett pops it up, left side of the infield. Relaford with a catch. Well, I'll let you analyze the first pitch.
I was a baseball player. I was a catcher. But a little wild. You know, I don't throw a baseball very often. So it's one and done. That's it for the year.
I could tell from your throwing style you were a catcher. Put that ball right up there on your ear.
Right to the ear, yep. And straight out. And, played baseball since I was a young kid and just love it. Love coming to the games. I don't get to do it very often.
Todd Walker is a pinch hitter here in the seventh inning. Well, your team got a great ovation before the game, and I know that feels good. And boy, everybody was behind Illinois, and actually we were at spring training at the time in Phoenix, and the establishment we were at watching the game, everybody was going crazy. They were so excited.
Well, if you were there with Arizona fans in the final eight, they weren't very happy, and that was an amazing game. And then, you know, just the whole run to the Final Four was just amazing. And, you know, you hear about it, you wish you were part of it, and then to be part of it, it's even more than you would even expect.
Okay, so you're down, what, 15 late against Arizona. And, I mean, what is going through your mind at that point? I know you're not thinking too far ahead, but it looked very good.
I'm trying to figure out how to get out of Allstate with the Illini fans chasing me. I'm trying to see if there's any back doors, emergency exits. But, you know, I told the kids at one of the timeouts, like the four-minute tie, I said, hey, you guys have done so well. You should be so proud of yourself. Don't, quote, go down quitting and just keep battling. And, you know, we hit a three and then another three, and all of a sudden it's single digits. And you just, you know, they kept their poise. I think that's the most amazing thing through that whole run.
Well, Coach, I think that's a testament to you. When the players respond well under pressure, that's a sign that they're being led well.
Well, they did it all year, and we just had a great group. They were bought in. It was just a fun group to coach. And I was just on the radio with Pat and Ron, and they were just talking about chemistry. Our chemistry was so great with all the kids, and they just battled every day, and every game they enjoyed. It was fun to coach them.
Well, let me ask you this. It's tough to answer it now, but what expectations did you have for this team going into the season?
Well, we got to figure out if D is going to come back first. That'll be the big thing. And if you have D, he'll be one of the best point guards in the country. You got James Augustine, one of the best big men. You sprinkle some athletes in there, you could be pretty good again. And the kids know what it's about now. They had a taste of it. Even if it's a Sean Pruitt who didn't even play much and he's at the Final Four just sitting there and getting a taste of that, I mean, that's got to drive that kid. Or, you know, and we have some other young kids. Marcus Arnold sat out, and all the Chicago kids, you saw them singing up here. They loved it. Kelvin Brock, and we got Brian Randall was redshirted, broke his hand, and we feel we have some pretty good athletes.
Deep to right field for six. Todd Walker with his first home run of the year. He
Maybe the Cubs are feeling some of that Illinois mojo today.
I think at the radio, I was just on. We brought five in for that inning, and the players brought. They were excited to be here singing, and we kept them hot. There's no doubt about that.
So Todd Walker goes yard.
Well, that's the kind of fastball that's supposed to be hit out of the ballpark, right down the middle of the plate, middle of the thighs. Todd Walker swinging a hot bat.
So a five-run lead. First career pinch hit home run for Todd Walker. And it brings up Jerry Hairston chatting with Bruce Weber, the coach of Illinois, and talking about this coming season. It'll be harder now, won't it? I'm sure that's something you'll talk to your guys about, that everybody you play, they're going to be really coming after you now.
Well, there's no doubt. And that it happened really all year. We had to deal with being number one for 15 weeks. It's the longest run in I don't know how long in the last 7-8 years in the NCAA basketball. So our kids were pretty poised all year. They know what it's about, like I said. And, you know, it's that winning is a habit. And once you create that positive habit of winning, I think it just kind of is contagious from one year to the next. At least I'm hoping.
So what is happening right now? I mean, what are you doing right now?
This is supposed to be our time off. The exams ended at like the 13th, 14th of May. We have a couple weeks here before camp, but because of success, we have a lot of guys that have a chance to be in the NBA draft. So I spend every day on the phone with NBA coaches, scouts, agents. You know, we got Luther's got a chance. Darren's going to be one of the top 10. Rogers got a chance to be. Powell's got a chance to be drafted. Jack Ingram's had some tryouts with teams. And then D. Brown, we've had to go through this thing with him. And so it keeps you busy. I wish I had a little more free time. We got camp starting in June, July's recruiting. And then the dumb coach is taking the Big Ten All-Stars on a trip to Spain in August. So no rest for the weary.
And I'd have to think that the team success is going to help those guys as far as how NBA teams view them.
Well, I don't think there's any doubt. You're talking about winning, and they want winners. I mean, and they love to. It's amazing how many calls I've gotten from NBA coaches, scouts, just to talk about our team and how they played together, how they played to win. Darren Williams could be as high as number two draft choice, and there's games he scored one bucket. So I think that's a true testament of he did the little things that make a difference.
Hairston strikes out, two down in the inning.
Well, success breeds success, and I'm sure winning 37 games this year, going to the NCAA finals, didn't hurt your recruiting at all.
Well, it definitely opens doors. There's no doubt. You know, it's just in Major League Baseball, you know, whether it's Chicago, New York, people, you know, guys want to play in those type of markets, and it doesn't happen overnight. It happens with success and having crowds and great exposure, and we're in the same business. You know, college basketball, getting on TV. We had more TV appearances, I think, than anyone else in the country, and it opens doors, opens eyes, and you hope down the road it's going to really help us recruiting-wise.
102 Nafe is outside 2-0. Let's talk some baseball. Over 40,000 in the ballpark today. Not very sunny today, but a comfortable afternoon. This is as good as it gets in late May.
There's no doubt. I don't get to come very often, but I love to come. And you know, actually, for my daughters, when it's hot and sunny, about the third inning, they want out. But they love it. We've been able to sit through the whole game, and it's been a lot of offense. Like you said, a little bit of the Illini mojo carried over to the Cubs.
17 runs combined, and the Cubs with 6 runs the last 2 innings, 8 in the last 3 innings. 3-1. So who do you like here? Are you watching a lot of the NBA?
Yeah, I do. I love to watch the playoffs. You know, I don't have much time during the regular season. Playoffs, they play hard. They play to win, and that's how it should be played. And I love how Phoenix played. I like the up tempo. I love Nash, but you got to guard somebody. Defense is so important. Offense can carry you only so far, and you got to guard somebody. And I think it's obvious you see that with the Spurs. And you know, people talk about the Pistons last year winning the championship, and they did it with defense and a team and a great coach. And they talked a lot about our team being that same type of team as the Pistons were.
Talk about playing hard. How about Scott Skiles' club after an 0-9 start? What
I was
year.
Happy because some of the attention up here went off of us instead of always everyone worried about the Illini. Somebody started talking about the Bulls, but he did a great job with a young group and got them back into playoffs. And you hope, again, now they had a taste of it. So many young guys. You hope it's contagious. You keep them together, and they can get this thing going again because I want you want basketball to be good in the state of Illinois.
Nathy rips one to right for his third hit today. Well, Coach, I mean, just talk about how important this city is for not only your program, but a lot of basketball programs.
You know, Illinois basketball, high school basketball is tremendous. Chicago's, you know, the start of it. There's no doubt. And great tradition here. And, you know, our first, obligation is to get the kids from Illinois, get the kids from Chicago to our place. And, you know, we just had, you know, six, seven kids up here singing, and they're all Chicago kids, and they were the foundation of our program. And, you know, we want to keep that coming in the future. But it takes time. You just, you know, every kid, you hope they want to come to Illinois, but you have to do it over a course of time. The Kentuckys and the Kansas and the Dukes and North Carolinas, they've done it for 10, 15 years. You know, we're a little bit new to this thing, especially, you know, continuous tradition, and we're hoping to develop that.
Derek Lee has not been retired today. 3-for-3 with a walk, an RBI, and three runs. One and one the count. Here's a pitch. Hit hard to the ground, but it's going to be Gonzalez to get the force at second. Coach Bruce Weber, thanks so much for the time. Congratulations, and enjoy your summer, okay?
Thank you. Thanks for having me on.
Cubs leading as they try to win this series 11-6 after 7.
Show off your pride with official Chicago Cubs merchandise. Hats, t-shirts, jerseys, jackets, and more. Let the world know who your favorite team is. Order your official Chicago Cubs merchandise today. Call 773-404-CUBS or go to Cubs.com. Wear your Chicago Cubs gear with pride.
It's go time at Toyota's nationwide sales drive with phenomenal selection at every turn. There's great offers on some of our best models, like 1.9 financing or $700 cash on the 34 miles per gallon Camry. Or choose a great lease. And do yourself a favor, check out the luxurious Avalon, starting at around $28,000, and it gets 31 miles per gallon. Toyota's nationwide sales drive is on now. Owning the winner's circle. Now that's moving you forward.
And now they're trying to take my life away.
Now when you buy a specially marked 12-pack of Heineken, you'll get 2 music downloads from Rhapsody and have a chance to win Sirius satellite radio and subscription, concert tickets from Ticketmaster, a subscription to Rolling Stone, or music downloads from Rhapsody. No purchase required. Go to Heineken.com for details. Responsibly means you must be 21. For more information, please visit EnjoyHeinekenResponsibly.com.
After the Cubs game, stay tuned for Cubs Post Game Live, presented by Joe's Crab Shack. Get complete analysis from Dan Plesac and hear what Dusty Baker says during his post game remarks. Cubs Post Game Live, presented by Joe's Crab Shack, after the Cubs game on Comcast Sportsnet.
On Monday, June 13th, the first 20,000 fans will receive a scratch-in win card with a chance to take home an MLB-authenticated autographed Ron Santo photo, compliments of Exelon. There will be 500 random winners. Fans are encouraged to hold on to their cards for second chance drawings throughout the game. And for complete rules, visit Cubs.com. Well, the 2, 3, and 4 hitters. Boy, the Cubs 9 hits, 7 runs today. Well, Ramirez in a big afternoon. Jeremy Bernitz with 4 RBIs. Right-hander Michael Wirtz works to Corey Sullivan. That's a strike. Joe Borowski with a scoreless 7. Swing and a miss. Thanks to Bruce Weber for joining us. You can just can feel the positive energy, the excitement when you talk to him as Sullivan is called out on strikes.
Yeah, that's a position that takes a lot of energy, I'm sure. Coaching at that level, getting your team to the national championship game. Good pitch right there by Michael Wirtz for called strike three. You better have a lot of energy.
Nothing in one on Clint Farmas. Roberto Novoa, even though he gave up that two-run single to Luis Gonzalez, has a chance for the win because the Cubs scored all those runs, five of them in the sixth, to get the lead back. Not the most interesting point he made is, you know, down 15 to Arizona. He's thinking, how am I going to get out of here?
Yeah. Stay away from the boosters.
That's caught by Nafe. Yeah, it did not look good for Illinois at that point. But a comeback for the ages. Well, it's so important to gather some momentum before a road trip, particularly when you're heading out west, as the Cubs will do to start a seven-game trip tomorrow in Los Angeles. And with the win today, the Cubs hold on. It would be a three-game winning streak, which would tie their season high.
And the offense, which had been fairly dormant throughout the first month plus of the season, has really busted out here at the end of this homestand. Obviously, Derek Lee doing a lot of damage, Aramis Ramirez, but up and down the lineup, everybody's starting to contribute.
26 runs the last 3 days. Time asked for and granted to Gonzalez. Nafe again to Lee. 1-2-3 go the Rockies in the eighth inning. Back first time they've gone down 1-2-3 today.
First came the award-winning CTS. And now comes STS. Lightning strikes twice. Cadillac, breakthrough.
Visit your local Cadillac dealer for this attractive offer and join the Hot Button event. Residency restrictions apply.
RZA Chevy becoming the number one Chevy dealer? P-R-I-C-E. That's right. Low prices. Large selection. That's RZA Chevy with a new Cobalt for only $88 a month. Upgrade your current vehicle and lower your monthly payment. Possibly get a check for up to $10,000. Remember, RZA Chevy is your home of $49 down. That's RZA Chevy in Bridgeview. RZA Chevrolet is the only place to buy.
Hello. Uh-huh. All right, I'll be right there. Bye-bye.
Time now for the Cadillac Sports Night Update.
Hi, everyone. Luke Stuckmeyer in our downtown studios. A dramatic day at the Indianapolis 500. Roscoe, Illinois native Danica Patrick trying to become the first woman to ever win the Indy 500. She had the lead, but with six laps to go, Dan Weldon passes. He wins the Indy 500. 23-year-old Danica Patrick finishes fourth. Much more on Sports Night at 6:30, but now back to Len Casper.
Luke, thank you. Aramis Ramirez is a triple shy of the cycle, a double, a home run, a single today. Aramis without a three-base hit this year, and he's facing right-hander Jay Witosik. Here in the eighth inning, Cubs leading 11-6. Witosik pitching very well. Nine games without an earned run, covering 11 and two-thirds innings. So his last nine appearances hasn't allowed an earned run. Happy birthday to Matt Wazolik from the Cubs marketing department. Stan the Man celebrating birthday number 81 this weekend. He attended his first Cubs game in 1939. Stan from Clinton, Wisconsin. Happy 81st.
Oh, that's Stan the Man. Thought you were talking about the other
right.
Stan the Man.
Norma Reed, happy 90th birthday coming up on this next trip. Is that how you're getting to the airport today? Might take a while.
I get there just as fast.
Been over a year since Ramirez's last triple. And it's been 12 years since the Cubs' last cycle.
The triples usually come to right center or right down the right field line, and for a guy like Aramis Ramirez, you need a little luck too. You need that ball to bounce around a little bit, maybe get away from the right fielder to give him an opportunity to hustle around those bases.
Not gonna happen here as he strikes out.
Witosik with a good hard slider that starts on the outer half of the plate and then just dive bombs down and out of the strike zone. Really the first bad swing Aramis has taken in the last 3 days.
Will Allman continuing to throw in the Cubs bullpen. Might see him in the ninth. Swing and a miss by Dubois. Topped off the plate, and a good play on the short hop by Relaford. Two away.
Relaford continues to make nice defensive plays no matter what infield position he's playing. This time cuts across, plays it on a in-between hop, and throws on the run to Todd Helton, who makes a nice play of his own on the other end, stretching into foul territory and staying on the bag.
Burnitz with two hits today, a single and a three-run homer, four RBIs. So he now has 30 ribbies on the year. See Jeremy's body language here. First saying, but then he nodded. Okay, all right, cool with it. He wasn't vociferous. I had a couple of shots at it earlier, but I whiffed. So we had to wait till the bottom of the eighth. Foul Foul tipped. That levels the count at 2-2. The win today, the Cubs would improve to 15-12 here at Wrigley. And they'll start the road trip 9-12 through their first 21 on the road. A strikeout to end the eighth inning. Two K's for Watosik in the frame to the ninth, and the Cubs with a 5-run lead.
More flights to more places than ever before. America is your backyard. Southwest Airlines, we're taking low fares farther.
You are now free to move about the country.
Edgar, I shall take the voice of this lovely woman.
This is Trump?
And put it into this damn head!
Why?
To tell the world the benefits of Aflac with sex appeal.
Brilliant, sir!
I know. Now throw the switch.
If you're hurt and can't work, Aflac can help pay your bills with cash.
Genius! And her?
Aflac!
This Memorial Day, feel free to drive a new Ford with 0% financing, zero payments all summer long, and zero maintenance for 2 years.
Six Cubs. Todd Hollinsworth into the game to play left field for Jason Dubois. And lefty Will Oman will try to close out the Rockies as the Cubs look for their third straight win. Mentioned John Lester, who, by the way, is now on the bullpen mound. Looks like he's going to get ready just in case here in the ninth inning. So he's now back in the bullpen for the Cubs. Cubs are going to need a starter coming up in Mark Pryor's spot Wednesday night. And the logical choice on the big league roster right now would probably be Todd Wellemeyer. But based on what Dusty said before the game, it doesn't appear as if they want to take Wellemeyer out of the bullpen right now. He has pitched so well. Welly just not stretched out at this point. So it could be Lester. Cubs could dip into the minor leagues yet again to find a starter for Wednesday, but they have not yet made their decision. We've discussed it many times. You just can't look too far down the road. You just try to figure out who's pitching tomorrow, if even that far.
Absolutely. I mean, you mentioned Wellemeyer is a possibility to take that start, and certainly the way he threw in relief of Mark Pryor after that injury would warrant another look as a starter, but then you start creating other holes. I mean, Wellemeyer has done a great job as the long guy. That's a very underappreciated role with the ball club, to have a pitcher down there who can come in when your starter gets injured or gets exposed early in the ball game and have a relief pitcher come in there and give you three or four strong innings and allow your offense a chance to get back in the game. And if Wellemeyer is inserted into the rotation, that leaves that role unmanned for the time being.
Well, because Welly has pitched so well in his role as the long man and middle relief, and in fact had to come in and get a save in Washington, just hate to tinker with it too much.
I mean, unless you're very fortunate, the first month of the season, even though you've been to spring training and played 30 or so ball games down in Arizona or down in Florida, as the season starts, as Helton grounds one to Derek Lee at first base, he'll take it himself. You're still trying to see how it kind of all fits together. Which starters can get me deep into the ball game? Which relievers can I count on in a close game? Which relievers are better suited to pitch in a blowout ball game? You know, how do my pinch hitters fit into this? How do my bench players fit into it? And finally, some of those roles are starting to become more defined. Guys are finding their niche down there in that bullpen and having some success. And at some point, you'd like to quit tinkering with it and just leave guys in the roles that they're most comfortable.
Ball one low to Preston Wilson, who hit a two-run homer off Ullman on a pitch that was way up out of the strike zone on Friday. In fact, Will didn't feel like it was a horrible pitch. He said it was so high, he felt like he was going to be okay, but Wilson went up and got it and hit it out. An email from Jared Macklin. What do you guys feel about people showing up the pitcher like Wilson did after they hit a home run? Well, we saw him go for some style points, and to be honest, Ramirez did the same thing as well when he hit his home run. Called strike three. Two outs here in the ninth.
Well, Todd Walker got a pretty good look at his home run as well. I've never been a big fan of it myself. You know, unless it's a game-winning homer in the bottom of the ninth inning or something like that, when there's obvious reason for celebration. But you've already damaged that pitcher. Just go ahead and run the bases, get back in the dugout, and let your teammates acknowledge what you've done.
Ullman facing Brad Hopp. Good fastball at 94 from Ullman. It's an extra mustard on it. Two strikes. Cubs are an out away from getting back to 500. For the first time since May 1st, when they were 12-12, with a win today, it would be 24-24. And a rather circuitous route to get to 24-24 from the 12-12. Boy, a lot has happened the last 24 games for this team. Struck him out. Ullman with a 1-2-3-9. Boy, it was a battle today. But the Cubs with that big crooked number in the sixth inning, a five spot punctuated by the Burnett's three-run homer. And they pull away from the Rockies today. It's exactly how you wanted to finish his homestand.
Absolutely. Offense swinging the bats as well as they have all season long. The starting pitching continues to be solid. The bullpen roles starting to get a little more defined down there. And now you jump on the big bird, head out to the West Coast, and go after with those teams from the National League West.
So the Cubs improved to 24-24, the Rockies with another road loss, 4-23 on the road, 14-34. So they're a full 20 games under 500 overall. Now the Hyundai player of the game, Aramis Ramirez, three hits, four RBIs, a double, and a home run for Ramirez today.
I think the overwhelming concern for the lack of offense from Aramis Ramirez was probably a little premature. Dusty said good hitters are going to hit, and Aramis Ramirez has always been a good hitter and starting to show signs of coming out of that early season slump.
Well, Jeremy Burnett's with four RBIs today, including a big three-run homer in the sixth inning. He's standing by with William Jackson.
All right, thanks, guys. And Jeremy, you guys had a seesaw battle going all day long. You provided the big blow, a little bit of insurance. Just talk about that.
Well, you know, it's been a battle for me up there at the plate lately, just trying to throw out my best ABs, and fortunately got a good pitch to hit kind of up, you know, middle of the way up, and put a decent swing on it, and, you know, thank goodness, hit a good one.
Four ribbies on the day, but this team collectively hit the ball well. You guys starting to come out, has to be a good sign.
Sure, it's looking good. Obviously, D. Lee is just, you know, he's been unbelievable so far, and now we got another guy looking pretty good. Aramis is looking pretty good at the plate, too, and that's big for us because he's a good player, and, you know, we're looking good. Hopefully, we can keep it rolling.
All right, you guys go to the West Coast feeling good now. Needed this win to get back to 500. Now you go with a lot of confidence.
For sure. 500's big, you know. Even just getting back to it is definitely a plus because, you know, obviously you don't want to lose more than you know, more than you win. So that's a big win for us. And like I said, we need to have a good West Coast run and keep it rolling.
Okay, Jeremy, we appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, let's go to Mitch Robinson in the studio.
Thanks a lot, William. Here's what we're working on for Sports Night at 6:30. Danica Patrick at the Indy 500 turned out to be everything we expected and more. You've got to see the way this one finished up. And look who's back for the White Sox. Frank says he's ready, but where will he fit in the lineup? Pat Boyle joins me at 6:30, and don't forget about Cubs postgame live in just a few minutes. But now we go back to Len Casper.
Okay, Mitch, thank you very much. So for Bob Brenly and our entire Comcast Sportsnet crew, Len Casper saying goodbye from Wrigley. Final score today, Cubs 11, Rockies 6. Our next Cubs telecast tomorrow, 7 o'clock, Memorial Day action from Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles. Stay tuned for Joe's Crab Shack postgame live. You've been watching Cubs baseball on Comcast Sportsnet.
If only all businesses were like Walgreens Pharmacy, then they'd be open 24 hours a day, too. So you could get things done when it was convenient for you. Even in the middle of the night.
Jeez.
Just like at Walgreens, where you can get your prescription from any of our 24-hour pharmacies, no matter which Walgreens filled it originally. Fortunately, there's at least one place that's designed around your needs. Walgreens. Why go anywhere else?
Customize your Cobalt. Brought to you by your participating Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. Purchase or lease a 2005 Cobalt and get a $250 allowance towards GM accessories of your choice. Customize your Cobalt into a tenacious tuner. Plus, get a Cobalt base coupe or sedan for around $159 a month. Residency restrictions apply. Call for lease details. Cobalt, the new commotion in the Chevy family. Join the revolution at your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers.
Can I clear these for you?
Okay, let me just...
F-T-M-T.
I'll just take these out of your way, okay?
Done? What about these? Are you guys done?
Yeah, there we go.
Wow, you know what? That new busboy you hired is really working his butt off.
Yeah. I didn't hire a busboy.
This summer, grab some Coors or Coors Light. Look for specially marked packages for your chance to win never-released-before music downloads powered by Sony from Kinect.com. Taste the cold. Get the music.
It's a wonderful world. I'm just walking on air. Talk of heaven on earth. I've got more than my share. Haven't got a care. Happy all day through.
Rico Dependability moves your ideas forward. Vacations, too.
Wonderful.
Get the best baseball experience this summer by entering the Crosstown HD TV sweepstakes. It's your chance to win one of three Sony 42-inch HD TV sets during the Crosstown series June 24th through the 26th. To enter, go to ComcastSportsnet.com, link to Chicago, and fill out your entry, or send in a postcard to the address on the screen. Then watch the Crosstown series on Comcast Sportsnet to find out if you're a winner. We're giving away three TVs in 3 days, only on Comcast Sportsnet. Nobody does baseball better.
Cubs baseball on Comcast Sportsnet has been brought to you in part by Southwest Airlines, nonstop service to over 59 destinations. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom. Robert Morris College, real college for the real world. The first ever Pontiac G6, Go to firstevergsix.com. Hyundai, driven by a commitment to quality that lets them offer America's best warranty. Jack Daniel's Tennessee Whiskey. Your friends at Jack Daniel's remind you to please drink responsibly. Cadillac and the all-new STS Breakthrough. Visit your local Cadillac dealer. Rico, how well do you print, copy, scan, fax, how well do you share? Nissan, who reminds you to ship the way you move through the world. Heineken, it's all about the beer, Heineken. And by Ford, built for Chicago, built for the road ahead.
Hello and welcome to Cubs Post Game Live, presented by Joe's Crab Shack, alongside Luke Stuckmeyer. I am Mitch Robinson. The homestand now over. It's time for the Cubs Roadshow.
That's right. Cubs end up now 6-4 on this homestand, 5-2 in those seven games against two of the worst teams in the National League. A critical stretch for the Cubs, and they get the 11-6 win today against the Rockies. Cubs now 24-24, Mitch, 500 mark for the first time since May.
Yeah, not bad, and they actually wake up the offense in this one, start hitting some home runs on this, and the two men to talk about, Derek Lee and Aramis Ramirez. Lee, phenomenal over this whole series, and Aramis Ramirez coming to life the last 2 days.
Yeah, they sure have. The Cubs offense putting together 26 runs over the last 3 days. We're going to check out our ExxonMobil game-changing moment right now. It was the Cubs in the sixth inning coming through with the big guns, and they come out smoking in the sixth. First up, Derek Lee with a single to center, scores. Hairston makes it 6-6. Next batter, Aramis Ramirez. And Aramis has just started to heat up, Mitch. He gets it done here as well.
Up the middle, base hit, scores a run. So Cubs fans happy to see this. The Aramis Ramirez of last year, it seems, coming alive.
And Nathy scores at 7-6. Then the Rockies would go to the pen after a Du Bois pop-up. Jeremy Burnitz unloads opposite field to left. It's a three-run homer. The Cubs take a 10-6 lead. They tack on one more. 11-6, the final. The Cubs beat the Rockies. Obviously a big win because those seven games against the two worst teams in the National League, if you don't beat them and at least win five of them at home, you're in some serious trouble.
And we'll talk about the schedule coming up for the Cubs over the next month and a half. It is rough to say the least, but now let's go out to Dusty Baker at the podium meeting the media.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we're starting fresh. Hopefully we can take some distance between us and 500. But the key thing is just keep winning series and, keep inching closer. I mean, we picked up a game today, which is great. And we need to get back to 500 before we went on this road trip. It's going to be a tough road trip. It's always tough, you know, going west. But our guys are feeling good about themselves and our offenses. Swinging the bats pretty good. It's great to see Aramis, come alive the last few days. And, always playing better baseball.
Surprising that the team's been able to handle the adversity forward despite everything that's gone on the last few days.
No, not surprised. I think, last year sort of prepared us for it a little bit, I think. Our guys are, very resilient guys. They know, every day's a new day. And we just got, do what we got to do to get it done.
So. Surprised that opposing managers one pitching to Jarrett Lee, and if you were an opposing manager, would you pitch to him later?
Well, you got to pitch to him sooner or later, especially at the bases. You got guys on the bases. I mean, nobody likes to run from anybody. I mean, everybody on that field is professional, and there's pride over there too. And they get him out sometime. He's hitting 370. You figure they're getting him out more than he's getting hits. And no, I'm not surprised because. I've seen them pitch to Barry Bonds. I've seen them pitch to Hank Aaron. I mean, they'll pitch to anybody. And like I said, those guys have a lot of pride.
You talked about the residual effect of Ramirez and how it makes it so much easier for the rest of the lineup when they have to concentrate on quality.
Well, I mean, he's going to hit sooner or later. That's what I was telling you guys the other day. I mean, this guy can hit. And if you can hit, then sooner or later, you're going to hit. it's surprising when a good hitter doesn't hit. But, you know, I mean, there are different years or different things, and, you know, he's starting to come alive, starting to see the ball better, starting to swing better pitches. And with that comes, you know, with results comes confidence, because when you're not doing well, I don't care who you are, your confidence wanes some. So I'm just glad to see it. I'm glad to see it happening.
Is that kind of a fail-safe if he's hitting good that they can't pitch around D-League?
Well, yeah, I mean, and then you got Jeremy after that. I mean, that was a big three-run homer that Jeremy hit, you know, after getting Debo to pop up with runners on first and third. So, you know, if you can get two or three or guys in the lineup hot, especially in succession like that, then you got a great chance to score some runs, especially if the guys in front of them are getting on. Well, it's adjustment period as far as you know, your sleep. You know, you can have sleep disorder a little bit early. So, you know, just urge our guys to realize it's a tough trip and realize it's a business trip and not a pleasure vacation trip. And realize that we're playing some tough teams that are, you know, the leaders of their division. And we haven't seen the new Dodgers since last year, and we've seen the Padres once, so you know we're probably more familiar with the Padres than we are. With the Padres than we are the Dodgers.
Dusty, where would you be without Derek Lee having been so hot for the whole start of this year?
Well, I mean, you know, who knows? You got to have somebody hot. I mean, where would Phil Jackson be without Shaq or Kobe or or Michael Jordan? I mean, you know, that's why you sign these guys. That's why you have good players, you know, on your team. So you got to have somebody hot to, you know, to give you a chance.
I think Dusty just called Phil Jackson out, saying he's always had a star in his lineup. Let's take a look at today's Felco pitching facts. And Sergio Mitre goes 5 1/3, does not get even one 1-2-3 inning. He did get 10 ground ball outs, 8 to Nathy Perez alone, but gave up 6 earned runs and gave up 3 home runs. And here is Sergio Mitre meeting the media.
I thought I threw the ball pretty good. I made some good pitches that got hit, and I made some bad pitches that got crushed. So, I mean, I just need to keep working and get back on it.
Have you been told right now you're going to be pretty much going out there and pitching every fifth day?
As far as I know, I think that's what I'm doing. So, I mean, just go back to square one and prepare myself for my next one.
Is this ballpark kind of a scary place for pitchers that are going out and can't pick the ball?
I mean, it's always scary. I mean, sometimes the wind's blowing in and they crush balls that don't go anywhere. And I mean, sometimes the ball flies out of here. But I mean, it's my job to try and keep the ball down and keep it in the ballpark.
Anything else for Sergio?
Sergio, do you worry about the rash of injuries to this pitching staff that it just seems to be almost jinxed?
I mean, I really don't know about that. I mean, many things happen. It's just, I mean, one of those things that you have no control over, and I mean, just try and overcome whatever we can.
Okay, we're gonna let Sergio go.
Roberto Novoa just called up, gets the win, and positive note, Joe Borowski, Michael Wirtz, Will Ullman, all with a scoreless inning of relief.
And they're going to have to count on Mitre with Wood and Pryor banged up on the disabled list. Cubs did make a bullpen move today. They called up John Lester from AAA, and we assume he's going to go to the bullpen, and that leads us to our Cubs poll question. What should the Cubs do with Ryan Dempster now? Move him into the starting rotation because they're so thin, or should they keep him as the closer right now? Go to ComcastSportsNet.com, click on Chicago, then on the Cubs page and vote. We'll have results for you later in the show. More Cubs postgame live coming up in just a bit.
Command in order to be effective.
So we're getting set for baseball. A couple of national anthems coming up. Wayne Mesmer with the duties, our Canadian national anthem, followed by